Sports Raider of the Year, Jason Wilde.
Is there anything anybody loves more than agreeing with Tausch?
Packers Hall of Famer Mark Tauscher.
I got a hunch this isn't going to be concise either.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio.
I would say that you are pretty easygoing. You're actually probably more easygoing than I am.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Well, you're not easygoing at all.
Hey!
On 100.5 ESPN, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
It is the Wednesday edition. The free agency rolls on edition. The Bryan Bulaga scheduled to appear and perhaps become the Secretary of Homeland Security in the next administration edition. The Vice President Aaron Rodgers, I know him. That can't be. That's that quarterback who did a show with me edition of Wilde and Tausch. That's a Hamilton reference. Did you get it there? Your face looks like you didn't get
the
reference.
I liked it.
Josh and Hartland appreciated it. That's why he's going to be a Hall of Famer someday. A 94.5 ESPN Milwaukee, 100.5 ESPN Madison, 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam. ESPNWisconsin.com, the ESPN app, your Alexa smart speaker, streaming live video, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and of course everything you need on WisconsinOnDemand.com and the Wisconsin On Demand app. I'm Jace Wilde in Green Bay, hoping maybe for the press secretary gig. Jesse Nelson is in the Everlight Solar ESPN Madison studios. And from his undisclosed location, I see him as maybe the Secretary of Agriculture. Big farm guy. Or maybe he'll be like the big tech czar, keeping things like TikTok and those types of things under control in the new administration. He is also a Packers Hall of Famer. He is Mark Tauscher. Tausch, good morning. How are you?
So would you vote for the Aaron Rodgers VP ticket if he ends
no.
up being a VP?
No, I would not.
Why not?
He's not qualified. That's why.
Who is qualified? Is an 85-year-old qualified?
I do not want to get into a political debate. I would like younger candidates. We agree on that.
Amen. So, and one of the things that I found funny about this whole thing, and obviously Aaron Rodgers
funny,
has been a quarterback, and he's had a bunch of takes. You could look at it from 100 different ways. But one of the things that I keep hearing, and I hear it from all kinds of people, and I'm sure you do too, is this the best we got? Or 82, and I don't know how old Trump is. I think Biden's 82.
Whoa, Nelly!
What? I'm not talking political here. I'm just saying age.
Jesse, are you so less comfortable?
Whoa, Nelly, all you want.
What's Jesse less comfortable with?
I'm not saying vote for this person or not.
Wait a minute. What's Jesse less comfortable with? Discussing politics or explaining the bar that he went into in St. Louis?
Whoa, Nelly!
Well, he's not talking. He's just hitting buttons right now. But in all seriousness, all we're saying is everybody wants younger people. Mm-hmm. Like everybody does. And then I don't know if this Aaron Rodgers thing, how much validity there is to it. I know he's endorsed Robert Kennedy. I know that he has spoken very highly
of him.
Who is
70,
but,
by the way.
Yeah, we want younger people, and then when younger people throw their hat in the ring, they're saying you're an idiot, don't do it. So you can't have – all I'm going to say is you can't have it both ways. You can say he's an idiot, everything else, but if we want younger people to participate – get in there.
We
throw your hat in the ring.
We literally can have it both ways. You can have a younger person who is also more qualified to be vice president of the United States than the quarterback of the New York Jets.
All right, give me some names. I'm all in. I want to hear it.
We're not.
No, I do.
Nelly.
No, because.
But I think the whole part
on 620 WTMJ, if you want to go there.
The whole part of the Rodgers thing here is, how are you going to be a quarterback and do the vice presidency? Like, that to me is the fascinating part. Like, how would he even try to do
that's
that?
The fascinating part?
Yeah.
The fascinating part to me is this is the guy who spoke out saying how the Jets have to eliminate distractions if they want to stop being a perpetual loser. And now
he's talking about everybody else.
He's having conversations with a third-party candidate about being his VP, his running mate. Because that's not an – I'm sorry, guys. I have to miss Wednesday's practice. We have a rally in South Carolina. But yeah, I'll be back before Saturday's walkthrough.
It would be tough. There's no question. The whole thing, obviously, it feels like it'd be like a Curb Your Enthusiasm type episode of what is actually happening here. But one of the things when I was on with Vinny and the boys this morning is how would you handle that? You're getting there, and all he would want to do during his pressers and the McAfee and all the other stuff would be to talk about his platform, then in essence, wouldn't the broadcast on CBS or anything else also have to bring Kamala and whoever is going to be the other vice presidential candidate? Wouldn't they have to be on the sideline to give equal access? And then could Rodgers do? I've always been a believer in the snap count, being able to utilize that for various advertising. This could be a part of his campaign platform, is to get up in there and to start talking about health care, big tech. Like, it could really be a fun little, because I think the Jets are going to stink. I think he could really have a lot of fun with his campaign as he's taking snaps against the New England Patriots. He could get everything's mic'd up. I think that would be the most fun of this whole operation. I do.
When you said that this sounded like a Curb Your Enthusiasm episode, did you do that on purpose because you're so knowledgeable? Robert F. Kennedy Jr.'s wife is actress Cheryl Hines, who plays Larry David's wife.
No,
in
I
Curb
think
Your
it's
Enthusiasm.
Larry David's ex-wife in real life, isn't it?
I don't think so. That's a television show. It's not.
No, but I think they were married in real life, too.
You want Rodgers to go up to the line of scrimmage and go, green, 16, universal access to local community colleges, set, hut.
Yes. That's exactly what I want him to do. Whatever his platform is, and he could have whatever platform he wants. That's what I think he should do. Yeah.
Are you voting for your old teammate
he
actually runs?
We all agree. Hey. He's not going to run. He's not going to be a part of the VP.
What if he does?
He is a part of. I mean, he's not going to.
Are you? You asked me if I would vote for him. I'm asking you now. It's your turn. Would you vote for him?
I have to look at the whole. I got to look at this whole picture. I still don't know who's going to be the other candidate.
You're such
a chicken. I'll say this. No, I'm not. I'm not going to be a chicken. I don't know. I don't want 89 and 90 year old dudes. That I know.
Okay. So how old is too old? Because Robert F. Kennedy Jr. is 70. Trump is 77.
Why don't you tune in to Scafidi? I'm gonna join Scafidi. That's when I'll talk my
right,
who I may
right
or may not
after you get
vote
done
for.
On Bucks Plus, because you're also very knowledgeable about the Bucks, as we've established on the show.
Okay.
Look, this is not a political show. We understand that, John and others. The former quarterback of the Green Bay Packers is mentioned as a possible running mate for a third-party candidate for president. If you think that we're going to spend 3 hours discussing what his platforms would be, we're not. But the fact that this news came out yesterday...
I do wonder what his platforms would be.
You do, yes. Well, I believe legalization of ayahuasca would be somewhere on the list because he believes in the power of that stuff. But come on, I mean, I was gonna dive headfirst into this and figure out which teammates would have cabinet posts.
That was my plan for today, because that I thought would be funny. Maybe you, yeah. Hey, Secretary of Agriculture, I'm sorry you don't think that's funny, but we're not going to spend a lot of time on this. But is this not crazy? Would you have ever imagined when we started this show, when Aaron Rodgers was the starting quarterback, uttering important American phrases like, we can run the table, right? Like, it'll be in a quote somewhere.
It's a good campaign slogan. It's pretty good.
That we would be talking in 2024 about something this out of this world crazy? No, I did not. Sorry.
I'll say this. Of everybody involved,
Oh my God.
I could see this happening. When you start talking about what?
I'm listening. No, I just... Cheryl Hines was actually introduced to Robert F. Kennedy Jr. by Larry David, apparently. So they were not married. They were not married in real life.
So they were married on the show. I thought they were married in real life and on the show, and then they got divorced in both cases. So I could be wrong on that. I don't even know if they were married on the show. But I think Rodgers is always looking. He's always, especially the latter part of his career in Green Bay. So you ask, am I shocked by this? I saw somebody tweet out yesterday, or you talk about cold takes. A hot take, in 2023, some guy said the Jets are going to be really disappointed when they trade for Aaron Rodgers, and he drops out because he's going to be Robert Kennedy's vice presidential candidate.
Shut up!
It is on Twitter. Check it. It's unbelievable. And it's post-dated April of 23. So the idea that this is some outlandish thing, no. I think he has always had strong beliefs, and I think he is, as his popularity and stardom grew, I think he's been more emboldened to be more open about his beliefs, and I think he thinks the system is jacked up and he wants to do something about it. So no, when you ask, am I surprised by this? I'm not. Now, doing it after rupturing your Achilles and all of the other stuff you just mentioned, is that surprising? When you're playing football, you don't have time to be running countries. I just don't think.
Well, maybe a smaller country. So,
Luxembourg, so, you might be able to get away with
it. Like, I think if he had retired and was doing this, I wouldn't be shocked at all. But the fact that he's rehabbing a major injury, trying to rebuild a really bad football team, and trying to rebuild the country, hey, if he could pull that off, what a deal. That's pulling off a trifecta if he pulls that off.
All right. Well, we wish him the best in this pursuit. He is not the...
You really didn't think, all the time you spent with him, you really didn't think he had this in him? Really?
I did not think that he would go this route. I thought he would be kind of a guy behind the guy type political guy.
Isn't that what a vice president is?
No.
The guy behind the guy?
No, I think you're still one of the guys. Like, one of the high-profile people. I'm talking about,
I would say,
you know,
a VP,
the kingmakers.
I would say a VP is a guy behind the guy, or a gal behind the gal.
Yes. But I was talking more in the background. VP is still in a prominent... I mean, your name is on the ticket for voting. I'm talking about someone who is doing all the moving and the shaking in the background, not on the ticket. But be that as it may, he's not on the ticket yet. You never know. Maybe Jesse the Body Ventura will get the nod instead.
Jason, there's no way he's going to be. That's why I thought when you sent this yesterday and it was from the New York Times, I thought, no way.
You thought I was tricking you?
I've been wrong a bunch, though. I was wrong about Aaron Jones. I was wrong about... you know, other stuff. So who knows? Maybe this is something, but it would be. And then the other stuff that was really funny was, what would he do? The Secret Service would have to block for him. Like, there's a ton of funny stuff that has come out of this little quip.
That's all. That's all we're looking for here. It's all we're looking for. Just have a little fun. There was other news yesterday.
Let me tell you something, though, Jason. Politics ain't fun. You know that.
It's not. That's why we don't
even
do a political show.
I agree.
This eclipsed the news of Keyshawn Nixon re-signing. Corey Ballantyne re-signing, that I feel like that didn't get enough attention because of this potential vice presidential run. But again, I'll be curious if he, how far he takes this before he says this is not realistic.
Can you imagine Bob Sala and Joe Douglas and Hackett yesterday just sitting there? They probably, you know, they obviously know that he's a big RFK guy. Can you imagine they're sitting there drawing up, okay, getting ready for OTAs and everything else, and somebody, their Jason Wallers comes up to him and says, I just saw this in the New York Times. Roger's going to be the VP for Robert F. Kennedy. Can you imagine what those guys are thinking? Like, what the blank are we doing? Like, you just think of what that reaction had to have been.
I would have loved to have seen him play last season. Obviously, he didn't. At what level do you think they are sitting there going, man, the juice really wasn't worth the squeeze on this?
The trade was made in April.
Yeah, April 24th.
Would Joe Douglas still make that trade?
No, I don't think he would. I don't think he would. I'm eager for Robert Saleh to face questions about this because, again, if the idea is to eliminate distractions, and that is the advice of your Hall of Fame quarterback, this is fun for us. But for the Jets, I don't think they're probably having as much fun with this. Like, dude, come on. Like, this is just another layer of distraction that we don't need. We're trying to fix this thing.
So this is what it was like for everybody else when we were dealing with it.
Well, he never was on a potential presidential ticket.
I mean, there was stuff, though.
There was stuff.
And we were like, it was 3 hours dedicated. Now we get to just kind of laugh it off in the first save. We're like, what a guy. And then just move on to Xavier McKinney.
Yeah, and that's exactly what we'll do. We'll talk more about what the Packers have done in free agency and less about Aaron Rodgers' political acumen. I'll tell you what, given the successful business she's run, I would rather have Gina Della as my vice presidential candidate. I know she gets the economy.
No question about that, and she revitalizes things, she replaces things, and you've been waiting to replace broken windows and doors, or if you do want to revitalize your home with a new look, now is the time to get it done. Because from now until March 31st, you can get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. That is right, Pella now and pay it up later, 3 years later, in fact. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation today at PellaWI.com. Certain restrictions do apply.
We'll get ready for Bryan Bulaga, who is going to be starting his own farm, remember? So I feel like the agriculture joke was decent with you, but maybe he's a better candidate.
No, because in fairness, Jason, I am nervous about where the dairy farm industry is at and what big government. So I am concerned about that. So maybe I should look into that. We'll talk to Blue about agricultural things.
Well, I've been accused on this show of trying to get you other jobs so you would leave. That was never the case. This would also not be the case as well. We'll talk about the departures and returns in free agency for the Packers yesterday. Next, it's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Ben Brust from Kyle Brust and Nortman to tell you how you can go to Vegas and have a chance to win $10,000. You can visit certain locations around Madison to play Pop a Shot to qualify for a chance to win. The top five scorers from each location will qualify for the finals on March 19th, and that winner will win a trip to Vegas courtesy of Bud Light to compete in the National Mini Hoops Championship and get $10,000 for winning that. On March 15th, visit Danny's from 7 to 8, Red Rock from 8 to 9, and Chasers 2.0 from 9 to 10.
Get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote by listening and educating you on all of your product options. And with Design Works, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
ESPN Madison is on Wisconsin sports. Catch up on anything you missed on the Varsity Podcast on Wisconsin On Demand. Brought to you by Zimbrick Honda, a proud supporter of Wisconsin Badger Athletics. If you're looking to purchase, finance, or service a new or pre-owned Honda, shop local, part of the Madison community since 1973.
Goodman's Jewelers has been providing a sparkle to Madison since 1933. That's a lot of great memories. John Hayes for Goodman's Jewelers. We've been caring for generations of customers, and during that time, our strengths have been trust, service, and selection. Those traits are who we are, and that will never change. Goodman's Jewelers, a destination worth reaching. 220 State Street, goodmansjewelers.com.
The best is at Goodman's.
Hi, this is Lee, inviting you to Ruth's Chris Steakhouse in Middleton. We got a great happy hour every day of the week from 4 o'clock to 7, and our patio during the summer is open too. If you're getting married, special occasion, a birthday, anniversary, or even a business meeting, we've got all the accommodations right here at Ruth's Chris Steakhouse. You work hard, and sometimes you're not sure what you want to do, where you want to spend your money. I want to encourage you to come into Ruth's Chris Steakhouse and say hello. It'd be a pleasure to meet you.
Life's better with American Family Insurance because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
The biggest names in the basketball world.
Dame Dollar Lillard.
Having fun and honest conversations.
He puts it in the shoe, right? And sets the tone for brothers and sisters and family.
Every week, Thanasis Adetokounmpo sits down with special guests on Thanalysis Show as part of Bucks Plus.
Fantastic.
Find Thanalysis Show on bucks.com/plus or download it now wherever you get your podcasts.
There's a good chance if you watch sports, you're getting served information about hormone optimization. What does that even mean? Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health can tell you exactly what hormone optimization means. He will take your blood work and let you know if it's right for you. If you're feeling sluggish, not losing weight like you used to, you're not gaining muscle like you used to, or you just don't feel like yourself in most aspects of your life, go see Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health. In fact, sign up for the 6-week experience so you can see everything that Carbon World Health has to offer, including hormone optimization. Learn more at carbonworldhealth.com.
For official rules and more information about every contest on 100.5 ESPN, visit ESPNWisconsinContest.com. That's ESPNWisconsinContest.com. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN app.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
All right, we are done talking about vice presidential quasi candidates.
So I just love this. I love this Rodgers. No, we are. But the Rodgers part of this, it is so crazy to me that a year ago we were sitting here and it was all Rodgers all the time till he was traded, and now the toxicity. Could you ever imagine that when you talk Rodgers, and it didn't matter what it was, not political, but just anything Rodgers, that our fans have almost unanimously told you no.
Threatened to turn us off, yeah.
Could you ever imagine that it would ever get to that point? Like, it never happens with any of the old players. Like, we obviously don't talk about most of the – like, Aaron Jones, we're not going to talk about him much till the Vikings come to town.
Correct.
Rodgers, Favre, obviously that's a different ball game, but it is fascinating to me to see how that is unfolded. It really is.
Although Aaron Jones did use the famous Mark Tauscher quote of "there are three sides to every story," I don't know if he stole that from you or how that played out.
I told you that was his tweet yesterday.
Oh, that was his. You were quoting him.
Yeah, I didn't say.
I saw it later.
That's not a Tauschism.
Oh, I saw it later. I thought, I was like, wow, he took Tausch's saying and used it himself.
I literally said, Aaron Jones said there's three sides to these stories. Oh. That's what I was like, okay.
I don't remember you saying Aaron Jones said. I feel like you said,
I'm sorry.
You know, there's three sides to every story.
I just thought that was original content.
No.
Someone texted in that the great philosopher Mark Tauscher said there's two sides to every story, so the third side is usually right.
Yeah, I may have said.
Well,
if you're going to run for office, we're going to pick through everything you've said on this show over the last 8 years.
I believe you will.
And yes, as people can stop sending me tweets and texts to tell me that at least Jesse Ventura was governor of Minnesota. Yes, he has political experience. I get it. We're not going there anymore. We're done.
He's got to be close to 82, isn't he? Ventura's got to be old.
As things that bother you go, the age of potential political people, he's 72.
He looks a lot older than RFK. Looks like he's like 58. You know, I don't know what he's doing, but well, yeah, geez. Jason, I just have again. I don't think we want to go down this road, but
you
have an age limit.
Only one of us is driving.
You have an
there.
Age restriction of 35. Why are we letting 90-year-olds? Like, I don't get that. If there's on one side, there should be a bookend. Let's just bookend this bad boy.
You have to be 35. You can't be older than 75.
Something of that nature, sure.
Okay. I would like to get to Bryan Bulaga on time, so I'm going to cut this short. We'll talk about Xavier McKinney and Keyshawn Nixon and Corey Ballantyne a little bit later in the program. Bryan joins us next, but not until Tausch reminds us for the one thing that everyone can agree on. Democrat, Republican, Independent, Coors Light is where it's at.
Coors Light, brewed with a three-step cold process, cold lager, cold filtered, and it is cold packaged, so it's made to chill. Born in the Rocky Mountains of Colorado in 1978, Coors Light's refreshing, it is crisp, it's only 102 calories, that's why it is Coors Light in my hand when I need a moment to chill. Celebrate responsibly, Coors Brewing Company, a Golden, Colorado.
Bryan Bulaga is the only man that can
save us. Can't
wait
to hear his.
Do not.
I'm kind of curious
please do not bring up. Do you think we should have an age limit on presidential candidates?
Everybody thinks we should. That is universal. Everybody thinks we should.
Whoa, Nelly!
Live from his donkey farm in Florida, Bryan Bulaga joins us next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
There's a new safety in town.
Xavier McKinney is somebody who is what exactly we're looking for this defense. Talk about knees, talk about fit. This is a great fit for this defense.
Nobody covers the green and gold like 100.5 ESPN.
Zimbrick Chevrolet.
When was the last time you had your oil changed or your tires rotated? Do you need new tires, a battery, perhaps some windshield wipers? Zimbrick Chevrolet Service Center is equipped to help you with routine maintenance, major repairs, and everything in between. Get your free battery inspection coupon and schedule an appointment today at ZimbrickChevrolet.com. Don't overpay. Shop Zimbrick Chevrolet on Main Street in Sun Prairie.
Main Street, Sun Prairie, Zimbrick Chevrolet.
Mark Tauscher here for Chalmers Jewelers. I've been a big fan of Scott and Garrett and the whole team at Chalmers Jewelers for years now. I go there, my friends go there, and most importantly, my wife loves it whenever I get her something from Chalmers Jewelers. What's right around the corner? Mother's Day. Show some love to the incredible women in your life and stop at Chalmers Jewelers, the place to go for that perfect gift. I recommend Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton and Madison.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
Whether you're an artist playing accountant, a barista trying to be a bean counter, or a student just looking to get started, the UW Credit Union app lets you be free to be you with free credit scores, free online bill pay, and the ability to send money to friends. Because with fewer fees, you can do more of what you love. UW Credit Union. here for every you. Join today at uwcu.org. Federally insured by NCUA.
Dog, I can't remember a game that was this good.
Yeah, you know what else would be great right now? Some food from the Great Dane.
I know, but we can't go right now.
Good news! The Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company is available on DoorDash and Uber Eats. Stay in the game with the full menu delivered from the Great Dane closest to you. Downtown, Hilldale, Fitchburg, or East Madison. Order today with DoorDash and Uber Eats or on thegreatdanepub.com. Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company, Madison's original brew pub since 1994.
Join Prairie Athletic Club and spring forward your membership today. Hi, this is Sarah Tauscher encouraging you to save now until the end of August when you join the pack. The Platinum membership is everything you want and more, including Pilates, hot yoga, bar, unlimited training zone, and boot camp classes. Discover the ultimate wellness experience tailored just for you. Not a member? Not a problem. Guests are welcome daily. Head to prairieathletic.com or stop in today for all their membership specials. Prairie Athletic Club, family fun community.
When you're having computer problems, you need a company you trust to get things working again, quickly and affordably. Madison Computer Works has been doing that for business and residential customers for decades. Our computer care plans take away the hassle of being without your computer or needing to bring it in for repair. Starting at only $10 a month, our local and friendly techs provide remote help and can fix most problems in just minutes. Call 608-231-8000 and sign up today. Madison Computer Works, computers that work for you.
The GRB Rays have established themselves as one of the top baseball programs in the Midwest and the country. GRB Academy offers training programs for players of all ages and skill levels. Learn from some of the best baseball coaches in the area and find the program that fits your training goals and your schedule. Spots are filling up fast, so visit grbacademy.com to sign up now. That's grbacademy.com. GRB Academy, baseball for the serious player.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit celebrationsentertainment.com. That's celebrationsentertainment.com.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
I've got some famous friends you probably never heard of, but back in Rutherford County, our crowd is second to none. You might not know them here in this big city we're in.
You know what that music means? It's time to discuss politics. No, it's time to talk tackle talk. And orange groves and donkeys. How about naming your donkeys Wilde and Tausch if your neighbors have Jason and Kelsey? He is a future Packers Hall of Famer, a future farmer of America, or at least an orange grower. And he is our famous friend. He is Bryan Bulaga. Bryan, good morning. How are you?
Guys, I'm good. How are you?
Well,
hey, how many?
We're off
Blue,
to a
now that
start.
You have an orange grove, how many oranges? Jesse, take that. Put that picture back up.
He doesn't have an orange grove yet, though.
Well, but look at all those oranges on the ground. What is the waste rate on oranges? That is an inordinate amount of oranges just laying there on the ground.
Yeah, you know, I haven't done my research on that yet, but I can assure you that we probably won't have as many as that photo is showing.
Okay, good.
But we'll see. Again, there's got to be some research to get done, and, you know, good question, the waste amount, what do I do with them? I mean, that's a good question. Do I feed them to Jason and Kelsey? I don't know.
Yeah.
I have no idea.
I don't know. You know? They may not like oranges.
I don't know.
I'm going to try and prevent Tausch from taking us in any path that I'd like to avoid. So,
thank you.
Bryan, your thoughts on the release of David Bakhtiari?
Yeah. Well, I mean, we all kind of saw that it was coming down, you know, coming down the pipe. But, you know, kind of my same thoughts that I thought about it when we discussed last week. You know, it was a great run. Obviously, the Packers needed to make this move, and, you know, we kind of saw the writing on the wall with it. And my only thing is I hope, you know, he gets himself right, and if he does want to play, he is right when he decides to play. So a great run in Green Bay, one of the best, maybe the best left tackle that the organization's ever had. No offense, Cliffy. But it was a heck of a run, and, you know, I'm happy I got to play with them, and I've built a, you know, relationship outside of football with the guys. So I hope wherever he lands that he's healthy and, you know, he can return to his normal dominant self.
All right. That was actually just a placeholder to prevent Tausch from asking you about the age of presidential candidates. The real question that I wanted to get to is, because you're one of the players who has gone through this experience like Aaron Jones did and like David Bakhtiari is, and that is the organization telling you, hey, we don't want you anymore. Thank you for your service. We'll issue some nice statements and tell everybody how great you were. We'll bring you back someday to retire as a Packer. But if you wanted to stay, that's great. We don't want you. And that's basically what they told Aaron Jones after he said, look, that's too big of a pay cut for me to take. I'm wondering, no one wants to be told we don't want you anymore. So it is, by definition, difficult and unpleasant. But is there part of you, having gone through it yourself, that wonders whether or not the Packers do a great job with how they deliver that unwelcome news?
Yeah, I mean, it's a tough reality when it hits you, especially when, you know, you've given so much to a single place your entire career. It's not like either of these guys have been bouncing around from team to team or spent 3 years here or 2 years there, or, you know, it's nothing like that. So when you've given so much to a team and you really felt like you've rooted down in a community and your family settled and everything like that, it's hard to hear that news. Now, I think Green Bay, obviously I don't know how they handled it with Aaron and Dave particularly, right? I don't really know those details. I know how it went with me. I mean, I've told the story, but I didn't hear anything until the opening of tampering period, and how I heard about it was Russ Ball called my agent and said, we're signing Ricky Wagner. So that's kind of how I found out. I didn't get a call. So maybe they went about it a different way this time. I'm not sure. Obviously, with Aaron Jones, they were probably actively negotiating, trying to figure out a solution to the two, which would lead me to believe that there was probably discussion like, hey, we can't figure this out. We're going to have to go in a different direction. And they did. With Dave, I'd imagine those discussions had probably happened earlier in the year, would be my guess. So he probably had a very good idea of what was happening. You know, he had that video made, which is a great video that he had on his Instagram.
You think he did that all by himself? You think he just screen recording and putting in music and stuff?
Yeah, I don't think so. Someone must have prepared me. And if he knows how to do all that, that's pretty good. I definitely don't know how to do that. So my guess would be that, yeah, I'm not – that Abby would have to do that. I don't – so to my knowledge, or to what I would guess, they had a heads up. And do they need help with delivering? I mean, no. I mean, they have a way of doing business, and they're going to stick to it. And you know what? Each team has their own way of doing things and how they release guys or move on from guys. And, you know, it's part of the business. And yeah. I would, like I said, though, I would imagine these guys did have a heads up. It wasn't like all of a sudden they saw it on TV or like, oh, wow, that's interesting. Then their agent calls them 30 seconds later and goes, hey, by the way, you've been released. So I think they probably got more of a heads up, which, I mean, I wouldn't expect anything different. I mean, you saw the restatement that Goody released about Aaron shortly after it. I mean, it was a pretty, pretty, you know, heartfelt message, I felt. You know what I mean? It was very nicely worded and all that. So I think it was tough on Goody not to be able to work that agreement out with Aaron Jones. I think it was tough.
Blue, how did the Chargers do it? Because there is no easy way. I don't care what they bring you a bouquet and say, I appreciate your service. Like,
fruit
it sucks.
Basket.
You're going to get – it's a slap to the face when it happens. Did the Chargers do it any differently? Because I don't think there is an easy – this isn't going to be one of those easy good moments in your life. It's just going to be a slap to reality, and then you bounce back, and as time goes, everything heals up. But I guess did the Chargers do it any differently than Green Bay?
Yeah, I mean, I got a call from Telesco right before the start of the new league year, and he just called and pretty much said, you know, hey, we're going to release you, which I was imagining that was going to happen. I mean, I kind of had my entire house cleaned out at that point. I was sitting on the floor when he called me because we had got rid of the couch. Everything was out of the house that we were renting. So
what'd you do what did you do with this stuff? Did you ship it somewhere? Did you garage sale?
Donated it.
What do you mean?
No, we donated.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, donated.
You're like Will Smith at the end of The Fresh
Prince.
But
you couldn't wait until after they were where you were leaving and have it moved 2 days after, so you're not sitting on the floor. You got that bad knee. You have to struggle to get up. Like, what are you doing?
Yeah, I mean, I'll just put it this way. I was expecting it, so we had the place cleared out. I mean, it wasn't a big surprise to me, so I was ready for it. I was like, you know, it was getting kind of late in the day. It was like 8:30. I'm like, am I going to be getting this call? Because, you know, the start of the new league year comes here pretty quick, and, you know, there's a roster bonus due if I don't get this phone call. So I was just kind of waiting for it.
Did you kind of hope that they miss the call and then the roster bonus gets paid and they're like, oh, blank.
It would have been an interesting situation, that's for sure. It would have been a very dicey discussion between Tom Condon and the team. But, I was expecting it. So, like, it wasn't a big shock to me at that point. And I don't think it was probably a shock to Dave. And obviously, as the negotiations were going on with Aaron Jones, it probably wasn't a shock to him as well. So I always look at it that Aaron Jones signs for the Vikings.
I think the shock to Aaron Jones was how much they wanted him to cut his salary.
Yes, exactly. Agreed? I was just about to say that. So he signs that deal with Minnesota for $7 million. So that means Green Bay was probably asking them to take it down to $5 million or somewhere in that ballpark. Mm-hmm. And that was a little bit too much of a sticker shock, and I don't blame Aaron for it, right? Like, he took the pay cut 2 years in a row, and now you're asking him to go from, what, 11.5 down to $5 million? Like, I don't blame him. I don't at all. You know, just being a, you know, knowing what running backs go through and his value to the offense, I don't blame him. So it's kind of the way it works out.
Blue, do you think do you think they did it right? Because we all, you know, you've been doing your show, you're joining us all the time, in the fact that Goody said heartbeat of the team, veteran leader. I was surprised when the Josh Jacobs news broke. And then I was surprised. I was like, oh,
so
this
is
going to be tasty. We'll have both. And then 20 minutes later, ba-bam, thank you for your service, Aaron Jones. Did Goody get it right, in your opinion, as far as how this played out? And do you think Aaron Jones is going to have a little remorse? Because you could tell with some of the tweets he did afterwards, he's pretty hurt by the whole thing.
Yeah, no, I mean, this is like Captain Hindsight. We'll have to see how this plays out with Green Bay with Josh Jacobs to really judge if Goody did it right. We all know what Goody said, you know, at the end of the season, about everything you said about Aaron Jones. Whatever he said, completely expect him to be on this roster next year. He's elite, you know, all that kind of stuff. So when I saw the Jacobs news come through, I was kind of like, I was like you. I was like, oh, man, both of these guys in the backfield? I'm like, this is going to be pretty good. Like, this is going to be great. And then
you just didn't tweet it.
Yeah, like, Twitter's
a hell of a deal.
Because I wanted to see, like, okay, so that means Aaron Jones and them came to an agreement and everything got worked out. And literally said 20 minutes later, the tweet comes through that he, you know, has been released. And, you know, I don't know how this is going to work out because Josh Jacobs doesn't do what Aaron Jones does for the Packers offense. And that's kind of where my questions about it is what Aaron Jones does is he does a lot of multiple things for Green Bay. He obviously is the running back, and he's very good at that, but they motion him out, line him up in the slot. He can run a multitude of routes, right? He's all over the field doing that. And Josh Jacobs doesn't really do that. You could say all his receptions were high. Those were from little checkdowns coming out of the backfield. It wasn't like he was running wheel routes and, you know, post routes that Aaron Jones did for LaFleur. That's not part of his game. So it'll be interesting to see, because now we look at Green Bay's backfield and it's looking pretty bare besides the one guy, right? Like, who else is going to come in and be what Goody likes is kind of that heavy back and then the speed back. Who's going to fill that? And who's going to fill that void that LaFleur loved to use in the offense with Aaron Jones moving him around and making him a chess piece? I don't know. And when you're paying – like, I don't know the breakdown of Josh Jacobs' contract. I don't know how much he's averaging. I don't really know any of that. Has that come out yet? Like, what the breakdown of that is? Or
it's four years, $48 million, but as Tausch astutely pointed out yesterday, he's getting a $12.5 million signing bonus, and his pay for 2024 is $14 million and change. So if they don't really – if he's not what they were hoping for, they can get out of it pretty quickly, which I thought was an interesting way to structure a deal for a guy who's 3 years younger than Aaron Jones and who you want to be your bell cow back. Because you're right, he was one of the best at running between the tackles in the league. That's basically the opposite of what Aaron Jones is. And while I give Tausch a hard time about his tweet, it made perfect sense to me that you would pair those two together and say, hey, we're going to invest in the running back position.
1 year.
Right, yep. 1 year with all those wide receivers and everything. Yes, I totally agree. All right, Bryan, one more thing before we take a break. I suggested that there are certain players that reach a point with the organization that, and I did not have you on the list, no matter how much I love you, that deserve to be the guy who, the old saying of, it's better to get rid of a guy a year too early than a year too late. They're deserving of, it's better to get rid of them a year too late. And I said, Charles Woodson, Jordy Nelson, and Aaron Jones fit that category.
Julius Peppers.
A guy who went on to have more success back in Carolina, right? Like another example in 16, one of the things the quarterback was really ticked off about, he wanted to come back. Ted didn't have any interest in bringing him back because he was old. Am I wrong to think that there should be exceptions to a basically universally throughout the NFL accepted rule?
Yeah, I mean, I think you look at that and I always like to look at it, especially from, is it better to get rid of them a year too late, but based on production of what they did the year prior. Like, I thought, obviously, Aaron Jones was really productive at the end of the year, like showed that he still has a lot left in the tank. And you look at Jordy Nelson. We all know Jordy was a phenomenal wide receiver and still played good even with the Raiders, and the Raiders weren't very good. Julius moved on, had, I think, 10 and a half or 11 sacks the next year. And Charles Woodson's was still good when he went back to Oakland as well. So, like, you kind of look at these things where it's like we want Green Bay to move on from older players if they don't have anything left, but those three guys that you mentioned have a lot left, and they had a lot left. And you just think, you know, if you keep around some of these veteran guys to aid in the growth and maturity of this team, how much does that benefit you? And like you said it, a one-year deal where you invest in the running back position and you really – because if you invest in that position, you're really all in to being like, hey, we're helping Jordan Love as much. We want him to continue on the same path that he ended last year where we were running the ball really well. We were spreading the ball around. This wasn't a one-guy show. This was a lot of guys contributing in a lot of ways. And if you had that 1-2 punch in the backfield to really rely on that running game, and you put Jacobs and Aaron Jones on the field at the same time, defenses are going, okay, like, wait a second, like, this, it gets a little more complex. And then you have Dobbs and Wicks and all these guys on the field at the same time. It makes defenses not feel too good about it, right? Like you're looking at a lot of weapons that can get the football. So I'm kind of with you that there's some guys that I think there should be an exception for. And to me, I think Aaron Jones has plenty of left. I really do. Like, and it's interesting that he signed with the Vikings. That's going to hurt fans. I understand it. And I'm excited because I get to watch Aaron Jones plenty, right? I get to watch him for sure two times this year. And I'll certainly watch Vikings games more intently because he's on the team. So, you know, it stinks. And I understand what Goody's thinking. But at the same time, it stinks as a fan and as a friend of Aaron Jones because I know how good of a guy he is and how I think he still had plenty left to give.
Well, we'll have to dream fearlessly about that Jacobs-Jones backfield because it ain't happening in reality. Tausch, tell us a little bit about what the Packers and AmFam have cooking.
Well, not for this year, but I think Aaron Jones only signed a one-year deal, right?
Correct.
Interesting. Yeah. Draft will be in Green Bay in 2025, correct? Well, calling all Packer fans, American Family Insurance wants to see you and a friend in Detroit for this year's draft. Enter the Dream Draft Day sweepstakes for a chance to win two tickets to the draft, travel and hotel accommodations to Detroit, a customized jersey, and I think Jesse Nelson is going to throw in a Detroit-style pizza. Go to amfam.com/packers to learn more. Again, go to amfam.com/packers for a great opportunity to go spend a weekend at the draft up in Detroit.
More with Bryan Bulaga next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin Sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
Making the switch to solar energy is easy with Everlight Solar. Mark Tauscher here. How would you like to start saving money while also helping to save the planet? I know you would, and you can. All you have to do is make the switch to Everlight Solar. Our family is one of many who have made the switch to solar over the last several years. We knew we had wanted to, but weren't exactly sure where to even start. That's when we met with the Everlight Solar team, and they outlined the entire process and educated us on the benefits of making the switch. It was super simple. Join us in saving a ton of money and creating a greener environment for our family and the community by switching to solar. Learn more and schedule a free consultation at everlightsolar.com. That's everlightsolar.com.
You, rah-rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Stroff.
This Badger Minute brought to you by your Badgerland Chevy dealers, proud supporters of Badger Athletics. Go to badgerlandchevy.com.
On Tuesday, the Big Ten announced its all-conference team selections for men's basketball, and four Badgers make the list. A.J. Storr headlined the selections, making the All-Big Ten second team and becomes the first Badger second team selection since Brad Davison in 2022. Chucky Hepburn and Tyler Wall each earned their second honorable mention accolades in their careers. And freshman John Blackwell became the ninth player in program history to earn Big Ten All-Freshman Team accolades. The Badgers are set to tip off Big Ten tournament action Thursday afternoon.
Get no interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Don't wait. You have to order by March 31st. Visit PellaWI.com.
Since 1956, Holman Lindsay Paints has been making paint in Wisconsin for Wisconsin. Because of their commitment to making great paint for Wisconsinites, Holman Lindsay has grown over the years to 26 locations in this great state. Headquarters in Sun Prairie with a state-of-the-art facility, Holman Lindsay has the paints you need to make your job better. From do-it-yourself to professional, Holman Lindsay has paint for everyone. Visit one of their local locations today in Madison, Sun Prairie, Middleton, and Janesville.
Ben Brust from Kyle Brust and Nortman to tell you how you can go to Vegas and have a chance to win $10,000. You can visit certain locations around Madison to play Pop a Shot to qualify for a chance to win. The top five scorers from each location will qualify for the finals on March 19th, and that winner will win a trip to Vegas courtesy of Bud Light to compete in the National Mini Hoops Championship and get $10,000 for winning that. On March 15th, visit Danny's from 7 to 8, Red Rock from 8 to 9, and Chasers 2.0 from 9 to 10.
If you're looking for a special piece of jewelry for any occasion, Condon Jewelers is always there for you. Condon Jewelers has the best selection of jewelry you'll ever find and guaranteed to have the lowest prices in the Madison area. Free shipping is always available. Visit CondonJeweler.com. or call 241-3406 and ask for Jim the owner, who's at the store every day. Shop locally. Condon Jewelers, the jeweler on the east side, the jeweler on your side.
Come see Thanalysis live from Potawatomi Casino Hotel on Friday, March 22nd.
Hey, welcome to another Thanalysis show. And we do welcome you on today's podcast.
Be there for the first ever live show for Thanasis as he's joined by his brother, none other than the Greek freak, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
I took off my shoes and I was like, go crazy, go hoop. That's all it was.
Stay tuned for info. Tickets are on sale soon. Thanalysis live in Potawatomi Casino Hotel on Friday, March 22nd.
Hey, it's Hunter Vaughn. ESPN Madison and Zimbrick Honda are celebrating the area's best high school sports stories with the Game Changers of the Month. Follow ESPN Madison on social media to see teams making an impact in their community. Nominate your local team today at ESPNMadisonGameChangers.com.
Wilde and Tausch on 100.5 ESPN is brought to you by Everlight Solar. Save money, save the planet. Everlight Solar.
I've got some famous friends you probably never heard.
Continuing with Bryan Bulaga. Dying to ask him which spot he would like in Aaron Rodgers' cabinet along with RFK, but I'm not going to do that. I'm not doing it. Not going to suggest
Whoa,
it.
Smelly.
People don't want to talk about politics. I see him Homeland Security. That's just me.
Whoa,
he's a protector
Nelly.
By nature. Protected quarterbacks, protect our country. Bryan Bulaga, the Packers' offensive line is now in flux. We knew David Bakhtiari, who only played one game last year anyway, was moving on. We thought that John Runyon was moving on. That turns out to be the case. He agreed to a deal with the Giants and did pretty well for himself for a guy that the Packers were rotating for the second half of the season. But their numbers are going to be interesting. They're going to have to add more than just one offensive lineman in this draft. We've talked a lot about Sean Ryan, who wears your old number. We've talked about Rashid Walker. Where do you think this line is now that the reality of no Runyon and no Bakhtiari has hit?
Yeah, I mean, and obviously I don't think they're going to bring back Yash, right? I don't think he's a free agent as well, right? So you're right. The numbers are – you're looking at depth and it's not there, right? Like you don't have the same depth that you had. Obviously they feel comfortable with the starting five that they're going to roll out there with Walker and Elton and Myers and Ryan and, Zach Tom. They feel good about that, which I mean, last year at the, especially those last 6-7 games, you would feel pretty good about those guys. And I thought they all performed well. But we all know what happens throughout an NFL year. I mean, guys get hurt. Guys have injuries. Things happen. You also want – I mean, besides Elton, this is still a young group. You want these guys to be pushed in training camp and have to compete for spots and not just be given things. So, they're going to have to address, you know, offensive line in the draft, which – everyone thought it'd just be going straight defense for a lot of it, but they still have holes to address on that side of the football as well. So it'll be interesting to see where they put their resources. And obviously it's still early in free agency and there's going to be veteran linemen that are out there. If there's someone that they like that they can get on a relatively team friendly contract for a year or two, they'll probably do that.
A Ricky Wagner type.
Well, yeah, potentially. I mean, I don't know.
Sorry, couldn't assist.
Potentially, but he was day one of tampering period. He was in late in free agency.
That's true.
So it'll be.
I'm such a jerk.
Interesting.
I guess love poking the bear, don't you? Wilde's a real jerk star, isn't he? This is where people think Jason's such a nice guy. Oh, he isn't a fan. All this stuff. It's, and he's just a total. It's,
and Ricky Wagner is a very nice fellow. He's a former Badger, but he was not Bryan Bulaga, who was coming off a really good 2019 season. It's not a dig at Bryan. It's more of a dig at the organization.
It's a total but dig it's, because
but
you know
it's
it.
It's a little
you
bit
smirked.
Of a tweak.
You
the
smirked.
Big fella too.
So, I guess I...
Sorry.
No, you don't got to be sorry. It's okay. I can take
yeah,
it.
Jason.
It's all right.
I can't.
He's not you.
My question would be, Tausch, Jason, do you think if there's a lineman that they love at the end of the draft or at the end of the first round, they take him?
Yes. Yes.
Well, I think that's yeah. – if I had a bet right now, I think there's the dude from Michigan who busted his leg up, Minter, who yep. I think they've had meetings with him. I think they want to draft a guy to potentially take Josh Myers' spot or to be a plug-and-play guy if Sean Ryan doesn't continue to advance. I think they want another stud that they have to play with, whether it's a left tackle type. I'll be surprised if in those first three picks, which, again, I don't have my the 7 out of 168 – there's going to be at least two of those spots are going to be O-linemen. I'd be very surprised. Yeah. And early, really early, I think, first or second round picks are going to be used on one of those spots.
Yeah, I think so too. I mean, especially if you can get a guy because, listen, as well as I think Walker performed down the stretch, right, and I thought he performed well. I mean, he played well in the playoffs. You know, I think you need somebody – to push him or potentially play better, right? Like you're looking at Jordan Love as a franchise left tackle. I feel like maybe I'm not saying that Walker isn't a good player, but I'm saying maybe you're looking at the left tackle position as a need, right? If you're all in on Jordan Love, which I would imagine that they are, obviously.
Oh, they're all in on Jordan Love, yeah.
Yeah, you're thinking left tackle. If you can have Zach Tom at right tackle, who's going to get a new deal, and you draft a left tackle that you love and you have him on a rookie deal for 5 years, that's about as ideal as it gets for you as an organization. And then you have a young guy at right guard. You're probably going to draft someone to play center or push Myers to play center or eventually replace him. Then you have him on a rookie contract, and then whatever they do with Helton for I don't know how much longer his contract runs. But then you're pretty set on the offensive line if you pick the right guy to play left tackle or, like you said, a swing guy that can go guard or tackle. I mean, those guys are kind of hard to find these days. Normally it's tackle or guard, and that's kind of the way it goes. You normally
seems
find
like
the swing
Goody's
guys.
Got a formula. Zach Tom, Elton Jenkins, Goody's got a formula that seems to work.
Royce
yeah.
Newman.
No. Yeah.
Is that a shot?
Yeah.
Just saying,
yeah.
he has not been perfect on the offensive line. Let's not
Correct.
Give him more credit
didn't he start
than he deserves.
16 games? Didn't he start 16 did. Games as a rookie?
He did.
Yeah, yes.
He did.
And then they benched him for the NFC Championship
yes.
game. Yeah.
Yeah. There. I mean, he got unfortunately he got
they
replaced.
Lost that game.
They did, and yeah. that would be why. Yes.
So I think there's definitely going to be some additions. Offensive line-wise, there's going to be additions,
for sure. So, Blue, before, I don't know how much longer we get you, Jason had a really good question yesterday, and we discussed this, yeah, we discussed this a little bit already, but I am interested in that veteran part of this, because now, leadership-wise, Aaron Jones was the leader of that offense. They got younger. Mm-hmm. I didn't think this team could get younger. They did, with D-Bock getting out of there. Is this as simply as we're turning the reins over to Jordan Love? Is this, you know, Josh Jacobs, obviously he has a C on his jersey, but how do you see that part kind of formulating? Because for the most part, it's been Aaron Rodgers and then Aaron Jones, and now do you think it's just, all right, Jordan, time for you to just be that guy?
I think so. I mean, obviously, Jacobs is obvious. I mean, he's accomplished a lot in his short time in the league with Vegas. So he has the credentials that they're bringing in another big name guy to kind of support that. But I think this is, I think this is – I mean, to me, it's very clear. They're giving this thing over to Jordan Love. Like, you're the guy here. Like, we're kind of getting rid of veteran players. Like you said, they got younger. You're the star of the show here. Like, this is your gig now. And, you know, not saying they're telling him to prove it to get that big extension, but they're kind of saying prove it, right? They're kind of saying, you know, all our chips are in on you. Now show us. And you do it. Like, this is your thing now. So it, to me, I look at it as I am a little concerned about who is going to be the leader and veteran voice on the offense. Obviously, we all want it to be Jordan Love. He's the quarterback, and that's kind of what we expect out of all these teams that have good quarterbacks, that they're the veteran leader. Obviously, Elton's there, but Elton's more of a quiet guy. He's not really, unless things have completely changed over the last few years, I think he's kind of the same dude. So they don't really have that guy on offense that is like that veteran go-getter that can just get in the huddle besides the quarterback and just settle everyone down and get everyone to dial in or during practice or anything like that. They don't really have that guy. So that's what worries me a little bit about the whole thing of getting even younger. Obviously, I think Jordan Love's going to take a step in that category and progress as a leader and kind of, you know, step into his own in that situation. But it's always good to have someone a little bit older that has a little more experience to support you and be that other, you know, voice next to you that can help out and that guy's respect and you know, that has been in the organization for a little while and has that pull within the organization. And they just don't have that. So that's the only thing that I look at this as that worries me a touch. But Goody knows what he's doing, right? I mean, you said he's got a formula, and it, I mean, a lot of talent offensively. Defensively, I think there's still a lot of questions that we have. Obviously, they filled the safety spot, but still a lot of other holes there too. Like, there's still a lot of things that I think need to be addressed. I think corner, I think linebacker, I think you know, I think interior they're fine. I think edge rusher they're fine. But linebacker and corner are kind of a area that they need to get better at. So when trying to fill out this roster, we know offensive line, we know corner, and we know linebacker. The question would be, can you find guys, say, especially linebacker, unless there's a guy that falls them in the draft that's just an absolute stud at middle linebacker, that you can find someone in the later rounds that's going to jump in there? Obviously, they have McDuffie. I like McDuffie. I think he's a good player. Maybe that's who you're intending to jump in and fill that spot. But you know they want to get someone in that position. So can you find the quality of player that you're looking for within those first four rounds that you can think as a rookie can be a day one starter and contribute right away? That's the question that I see. And obviously, like I said, free agency is still going on. Guys will become available. We're kind of looking. I mean, I was just looking at it today. Like, tons of teams still over the cap. Like, tons mm-hmm. of teams before the new, like, Miami, Buffalo.
The Chargers.
The Chargers. There's still a bunch of teams that have
guys
that –
They still have dead money from you, Blue, don't they? Or they still got dead money from your contract?
No, I don't think so. I think they're cleaned out from that. I think they're free and clear. They've washed their hands of that. They're good.
But Bosa. Bosa and Khalil Mack. They're going to have to do something with all those
Mike
guys.
Williams.
There is another wave that will be coming at 3 o'clock or whatever time the league year actually starts.
Yep.
That they weren't able to renegotiate. So there is still a lot. A lot of ball game left when it comes to all of the transactions that are still going to be available.
Tons of talent. Tons of talent still going to be coming through for sure.
All right. There's no way we can let you go at 10:08 because that would be early compared to when we usually let you go. So my last question is this. Is it possible, and I know this is a controversial take, I don't even agree with it, but is it possible... Sorry, Jesse. Is it possible that leadership isn't as important as we all think it is? Do you know when they cut Devondre Campbell today, do you know how many 30-year-old players will be on the Green Bay Packers roster?
One. Preston? One.
Preston Smith is 31. I'm sorry. And Goody has a formula, as we've learned during today's discussion. But one guy who's had his 30th birthday?
Young man's game.
It can be a young man's game with a few older guys sprinkled in, though. No?
Yeah. Yeah. No, listen, it's the only thing that concerns me about it. It's the only thing because, like, we all learned last year that, you know, they started slow and then they picked it up and you're like, oh, maybe, you know, this youth, you know, they all kind of grew up. They all grew up. But now they're starting this thing fresh with literally, I mean, there's guys that have played football and like guys like Elton have played a lot of ball and things like that, but there's not a lot of guys that have played a lot of ball, right? Like, and that's what you get with those guys in their 30s. And I'm not saying that, you know, that they should just go buy a bunch of 32-year-olds and to satisfy a quota here. Like, that's not what I'm saying. But there is value to having guys.
No, it's not.
But what I'm saying, there is value to having guys that have been around and experienced a lot of things throughout the league. It's good for coaches to have those guys. Like, to be honest with you, to bounce things off those guys, ideas off those guys, to try to get a message across. There's positives to that. So, yeah, I mean, that was kind of my thing last year, was like, who are the veteran guys on this team? And they end up making it all the way to the second round. They should have made it to the NFC Championship. And I guess I was wrong there. But now we're starting out fresh again. And I think the same question is still there. Mm-hmm. And maybe they'll just shut me up again. And I'll just say, you know what? I want every guy in this team on a first contract, and that's all I want. And that's the way you need to approach it. Because it is a young man's game. I understand that. But there's plenty of guys over 30 that can still play well and do well. So it'll be interesting to see what they do throughout the rest of this free agency period and in the draft.
Bryan, you will never be a salary cap casualty on this show. We appreciate you, buddy. Thank you.
All right. Good one.
That is the great Bryan Bulaga. We always appreciate his extended time with us. We'll kick off the 10 o'clock
Jesse's
hour.
Jesse's kind of mad at you.
I noticed that. Yeah. This is not even a record, by the way. So I don't know why he's so mad at me. But be that as it may, he is mad. So let's make him even more mad. And you could tell us about Fortria before we end the 9 o'clock hour.
Oh, I will. If you're looking to get down by Bulaga, get down to Florida for a little spring break trip, get some oranges. You need a little extra cash. Fortria's got you covered. Healthy adults ages 18 to 60. BMI 18 to 32. Study involves two stays, 15 nights, and almost $14,000 for your time and participation. Another trial. Healthy adults ages 18 to 55. You got to be a little heftier. Body mass index of 18.5 to 32. That study is one stay. 14 nights with two follow-ups. You grab yourself $6,566 for that trial as well. Visit FortriaClinicalTrials.com. That's Fortria, F-O-R-T-R-E-A, ClinicalTrials.com.
The 10 o'clock hour starts in 2 minutes. It's Wilde and Tausch.
Don't go anywhere. Another hour of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
Mark Tauscher here, and when I was on the hunt for a hot tub, I found Patio Pleasures, a locally owned family business. Patio Pleasures has a passion for making your home a place for recovery and relaxation. And that's why I'm excited about my new cold plunge from Patio Pleasures. They only showcase premium recovery and relaxation products, and that's how I know it's going to be great. Gear up for spring and check out Patio Pleasures' two incredible showrooms, Madison West and Sun Prairie.
Hi, this is Dave Kane. You're listening to Madison's Home of the Bucks, a Good Karma brand radio station, 100.5 ESPN WTLX Monona, Madison.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio, this is your Metro Kia of Madison Sports Center.
Good morning, Madison and streamers everywhere. I'm Jesse Nelson, Sports Center, brought to you by Goodman's Jewelers, the diamond store of Madison for generations. Check them out, 220 State Street and online at goodmansjewelers.com. The NFL free agent frenzy for the Green Bay Packers continuing
3 o'clock today is the time when players can officially sign with their new teams or their current teams. The Green Bay Packers agreeing to terms with a number of free agents over the last couple of days, including running back Josh Jacobs, safety Xavier McKinney, and a couple of deals with current players, Corey Ballantyne, Keyshawn Nixon, two of the latest intending to return with the Green Bay Packers. Rob Domofsky outlines all the details of those contracts over at ESPNWisconsin.com. You can also find ESPN's panel of NFL experts weighing in with their grades on some of the free agent signings for the Green Bay Packers and other teams around the league. Plenty of reactions continuing right here all day on 100.5 ESPN, including more Wilde and Tausch coming up next. College basketball, the Big Ten tournament tips off today in Minneapolis. The Wisconsin Badgers, the number 5 seed, will face the winner of Rutgers and Maryland tomorrow. Approximate tip time set for 1:30.
Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or MetroKiaOfMadison.com.
Clock out. Wilde and Tausch begins now. Tausch, I did want to get that question to Bryan. I did not want to make him stick around for it. I'm sorry that I upset Jesse by doing that. But I am wondering, because you are a Goody believer, there's no doubt about it, and I cannot be overly critical of him after what they did last year, after the way he restocked the offensive shelves. I can't be harsh critic of him, but I do wonder if there is a, I don't want to call it a blind spot, because we'll see. They could go win the Super Bowl this year with only Preston Smith as a 30-year-old on their roster. But when you see the way this team is constructed, is there any part of you that wonders if this is missing a key component? And we made the point yesterday that both Xavier McKinney and Josh Jacobs were captains on their team. The Packers didn't have captains, because when people don't get picked as captains in Green Bay, they get very upset and they have jewelry or they appoint themselves captain for a single game. So it creates some issues. But, like, again, I'm not looking to nitpick here. I just have never – I agree it's a young man's game. But I don't know if it's possible to just say we don't need anybody who has a ton of experience and a ton of wisdom – other than Preston Smith on our roster.
Yeah, I think outside of the quarterback position, or if you're talking about those Hall of Fame players that Blue was just talking about, Julius Peppers, Charles Woodson, I don't know if Jordy will be a Hall of Famer. He's obviously a Packer Hall of Famer. But guys that have been elite players, I think you have to look at a little bit differently, but that is where you get in trouble. That's how you end up in a position like the Los Angeles Chargers are in.
Yep.
Paying Khalil Mack a truckload of money and then pushing that down the pipe, and all of a sudden it's March 14th, 13th, league year starts, and you're looking at it saying, oh, man, we paid him a ton of money and he's been hurt. Yeah, you know, the bottom line is the stats and the analytics will tell you that when you get to be a 30-year-old player, most guys' production starts to drop. And their production drops because they're injured more or they're not as available with you know, something else. It's just that's what it shows. And I keep coming back to what the Packers have done in the past. And they've been pretty consistent with, especially with linemen, where they'll say, all right, we'll pay you up until you're about 28, 29, and then we move on. And they've been right almost every time. You look at wideouts. They've been right pretty much every time. I know you can argue the Jordy component with Aaron, and I think that's fair. So when you do the Preston Smiths and you pick a couple of guys, what you saw last year is only going to embolden Goody's thought process on roster building.
Mm-hmm.
And when you strike it big
And now you have all these young core players that you're going to be able to extend earlier. And when you extend earlier, you get them at a better price. That's the model that the Green Bay Packers want to use. And they have had a ton of success over a long period of time doing it this way. So they're not going to change their ways. And we shouldn't be surprised when they don't.
They have definitely had success going back to Ted, being a draft and develop, always have a young roster. But I think this is a different level of moving on from older players en masse. Like, never did Ted have a team where there was one 30-year-old and that was it. So that is different. And my question now becomes, you know, Elgton Jenkins has two more years on his contract after the 2024 season. He'll be 31 when his contract expires. So you're not bringing back Elgton Jenkins on a third contract, right?
If you get him at your price, you will. And if you don't, you'll let him go. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what they do.
It
is. You have to remember, they're going to have to pay Zach Tom a large contract. They only want to pay two guys. That's kind of, they'll pay two big boys, and then they'll sprinkle, and then they'll draft and redevelop. So my guess is Elgton Jenkins, his contract, I think he's already outperformed it. Mm-hmm. So I would think that's going to be something to watch in the next 2 years. I'm not saying it'll be this year, but I don't know exactly what he's going to be looking around, seeing what Landon Dickerson and some of these other guards got. And he's a big-time player. He's going to be looking. So I would guess you're either going to see a short sprinkle extension, or there's going to be a little bit of angst amongst Elgton and how that plays out. That would just be my hunch. I don't think it'll be this year. I think it'll be when he doesn't have guaranteed money left on his deal.
What is Johnson & Sons' paving policy on, say, 40-something-year-old interns? Do they have some reservations about someone who's at your age, or do they feel pretty confident that you're going to be able to hit the ground running?
So I think in the office part of it, they like experience. They've had a bunch of people with decades of experience. They got the civil engineers on staff. They like youth and enthusiasm. I might not be young, but I am enthusiastic, and I am excited. I am going to be doing a gig with Johnson & Sons Paving, and you can have me as a part of your gig. I think it's going to be Friday now. Jason and I will do our next week's reveal for the Johnson & Sons paving team.
Thanks for letting me know.
But you better get moving on it if you're thinking about doing it this year. Now is the time to set those preferred dates for booking Johnson & Sons paving. And whether it's asphalt or concrete, they do set the standard. Maybe you need patching now, but you'll want that full repave later. Talk with a project manager. Set yourself up with that 5-year game plan. Get your paperwork done so that old T will come out to your project. I'm not sure how hard I'm going to work, but you know I'm going to show up with my lunch pail, and I am going to move some concrete. I'm going to move a little asphalt, whatever you need. Old T will do it, and we'll get it done the right way. Get started now at JohnsonAndSonsPaving.com.
We promised some Xavier McKinney talk today. And there was a funny little thing on Twitter. I don't know if you saw this. He's trying to decide what number he's going to wear for the Packers. Did you catch this?
I did not. Oh, you mean about Bart Starr?
He was considering 15. As it turns out, that one will not be available. We'll talk about...
What happens if he asks for number 5?
That is technically not retired. It's technically not retired.
I kind of want to see someone ask for 5 and see what happens.
Well, we'll talk about that, and more importantly, how he fits what the Packers intend to do defensively, as promised. Well, Xavier McKinney talk next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy.
We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote by listening and educating you on all of your product options. And with DesignWorks, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tauscher here for my friends at Kohler Services. If you need a bath or shower remodel, turn to Kohler Services. Family owned for 150 years. Kohler is your Wisconsin manufacturer providing care for life. This month only, get $1,000 off your Luxstone shower and pay nothing until 2025. Visit KohlerServicesWI.com to request your free quote with fast, professional installation always included. Again, that's KohlerServicesWI.com.
All five divisions, all five state champions crowned.
For the first time since 1934, state champion.
And they'll raise the gold ball. Division five state champion.
The WIAA State Boys Basketball Championships.
Brilliant Lions have won the Division three state championship here at the Kohl Center.
Zimbrick Honda's championship presentation of Prep Mania from the Kohl Center. Saturday on 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit CelebrationsEntertainment.com. That's CelebrationsEntertainment.com.
Panic strikes as you realize on Wednesday that Thursday is your anniversary. The reservations? Being secured.
We'll see you at 8.
The gift? Being purchased. Yeah, you've got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with early pay up to 2 days early on direct deposits. So even though they call you last minute Lisa, we'll make your last minute scrambling a bit easier. You've got this with early pay from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
The host might be irrelevant, but the conversations aren't.
Bryan Gutekunst is cooking.
Mr. Irrelevant with Alex Strofe.
Josh Jacobs, upgrade at running back. Xavier McKinney, an upgrade at safety. The general manager of the Green Bay Packers proving he is a very good general manager. Cooking.
Mr. Irrelevant with Alex Strofe. Live on ESPN Madison's YouTube every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And available wherever you get your podcasts.
You're probably being overwhelmed with information about semaglutide, the game-changing FDA-approved weight loss treatment. Jim Rutledge here. I was like you. I didn't know what it was until I saw Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health. He can walk you through the benefits. He can tell you if it's right for you, and then you could come up with a plan to change your life with a workout plan and semaglutide. With that plan, I dropped from 20% body fat to 10% body fat, and I dropped over 20 pounds of fat and kept my muscle. You can do the same thing. Go see Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health.
Ben Brust here to tell you about the Princeton Club. I joined the Princeton Club because I was looking for a place I could invest in my health, and the environment and the community I have felt has made it so easy for me to incorporate it into my everyday life. It doesn't matter where you're at in your fitness journey, because they have something to offer everyone. It also goes beyond fitness. From the moment you walk in the club to the moment you walk out, there is a togetherness felt throughout the members and staff that keeps you going for your better tomorrow. Don't wait any longer and get started on your fitness journey today at PrincetonClub.net. That's PrincetonClub.net.
There's a new safety in town.
Xavier McKinney is somebody who is what exactly we're looking for this defense. Talk about needs, talk about fit. This is a great fit for this defense.
Nobody covers the green and gold like 100.5 ESPN.
I say, hey, I'll be gone today, but I'll be back home around the way. It seems like everywhere I go, the more I see, the less I know.
So there are two, since Tausch is so intrigued by this, I would like to get to some substantive Xavier McKinney talk at some point, but whenever Tausch tweets, I know it's something that's really piqued his interest. So there are two numbers that are controversial when it comes to the Packers retiring numbers. Cliff Crystal did a piece on this.
I think I know them.
A few years ago.
I think I know which numbers.
Okay.
I think it's number 5 and number 66.
Well, you're half right. So the numbers game. I remember that. What number did Kurt Warner wear? So number 5.
I think the same number as Eli Manning, right?
So yeah, apparently. So number 3 for Tony Canadeo is retired. And I think if you read Cliff Crystal's piece, there would be a suggestion that maybe it did not merit retirement. He apparently was not pleased at one point, according to the story that Cliff reiterates, when he showed up at training camp after he'd retired as a player and he was working as a salesman in Stevens Point, lovely area. And he came to training camp and saw the first-round pick wearing his number 3 jersey, and he raised a stink. Now, you never did that with number 65 when they gave it to Lane Taylor.
They would have told me to kick rocks anyway. So,
the question about number 5 is Paul Hornung not deserving of having his number retired?
I mean, Paul Hornung had a heck of a career with the Green Bay Packers, but there's a lot of guys that have had a heck of careers. Why is it in limbo? Why do we not know? Like, we know Bart Starr's number's retired.
Lombardi said that as long as I'm here, number 5 will not be worn by anyone else.
Well, Lombardi's not there now.
Yeah, it's been a while.
You're right. They've had a few coaches since then. But no one – there were times when it would be issued in training camp to players, but then once the roster was set, no one would wear it. And so it is, as Cliff describes it, unofficially retired.
What does that mean? Unofficially retired. What does that mean? It's either retired or it's not. You're unofficially pregnant? Like, it's kind of the same thing, isn't it?
Again, I don't know. This is why it's controversial. Is that you're.
What is it? It's unknown. It's either is or it isn't.
It's not that simple.
Oh, right?
Right.
No,
but it's
it
not
is.
That simple. No, it's not. They're not issuing
it. No, but it should be.
Well.
Okay, so it's retired.
That's the question. They should be issuing it because it's not retired, and yet they're not issuing.
Issue it out. Yeah.
Okay. Again, this is a confusing policy that the Packers have not changed.
Xavier McKinney, ask for number 5. Let's get an answer. Let's get some clarity on the Paul Hornung situation. Let's get a little clarity.
In 1987, Don Majkowski wore it briefly. And then he switched to number 7 out of respect for Hornung.
Okay.
So, again, this is it's an interesting piece, but, again, it is not officially retired, but no
so
one ever
Reggie
wears
White's
it.
So Reggie White officially is retired,
so
correct?
This is further evidence that the Packers are not very good at retiring numbers because they retired Reggie's jersey. But they didn't technically retire his number. They had like a ceremony on the field. Ron Wolf was still the general manager. They celebrated him. He was still alive. But they didn't actually take the number out of circulation officially and put it up on the facade till after Reggie had died and Sarah and his kids came for that event. So... they need to clean up their jersey retirement policy, and you think that Xavier McKinney is just the man to do it by demanding number 5 to be his number.
No, don't demand. Just say, hey, man, I don't know what your guys' policy is on this. I know Bart Starr's number is retired. What's the deal with 5? I love number 5. Let's see what happens.
Apparently Forrest Gregg, who maybe – I don't know, maybe he didn't like Paul Hornung when they were teammates, issued it multiple times during his time as the coach. Gave it to
this
Vince Ferragamo.
No, does this make any sense? Does this make any sense to anyone?
I know what we should do. I got the solution. When Wisconsin plays Notre Dame at Lambeau Field, whenever that's coming up, 25, whenever, whatever year that is, they should retire Paul Hornung's number during the Notre Dame-Wisconsin football game.
It's a great idea. Maybe they can do it during the Northwestern-Wisconsin football game.
The home game for Northwestern, yeah.
All right. That was some substantive discussion of Xavier McKinney. We'll pay off that promise because I think you can make the argument, which you were making before free agency officially started negotiating, that this is exactly the type of guy Goody looks for. Ascending, best football still in front of him, willing to pay not for what you've done, but what we think you've done, you're going to do. I think
I'm
that's
still
exactly
confused why the I'm still confused why the Giants would let someone like that out of their building.
Yeah,
I don't get that.
I don't either. We'll talk about that at some point other than next because we're going to talk to Homer next. Want to remind you
on a Rogers that's Vice President Day. Oh boy.
Boy. After last week's, I'm going to be especially nice today. I am going to be over the top nice.
Okay. Well, we'll see if you can stick with that. We'll see what the old fella says that maybe riles you up a little bit. Homer joins us next. Want to remind you, Gruber Law Offices, one call, that's all. David and his team, congrats on becoming a grandpa yet again to David. I saw in the Bally Sports Wisconsin telecast last night that the Watsons have a new baby. And so that's exciting as well. But you know that David has been here for us and here for this show and here for this station. He has been a longtime partner, and we appreciate everything he does for us. And we're excited to tell you about that kind of great news that they shared on Bally Sports Wisconsin last night. Hopefully you have nothing but good news. Hopefully you don't have any bad news, like you've been in an accident and you've been seriously injured. But if you have, one call, that's all. Go to gruber-law.com to find out more about the firm. Or give them that call, 414-276-6666, 414-276-6666. Homer joins us next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, driven by Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie on 100.5 ESPN. See their full inventory at ZimbrickChevrolet.com.
Mark Tauscher here for Chalmers Jewelers. I've been a big fan of Scott and Garrett and the whole team at Chalmers Jewelers for years now. I go there, my friends go there, and most importantly, my wife loves it whenever I get her something from Chalmers Jewelers. What's right around the corner? Mother's Day. Show some love to the incredible women in your life and stop at Chalmers Jewelers, the place to go for that perfect gift. I recommend Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton and Madison.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
It's time for the Milwaukee Basketball Report on 100.5 ESPN. Brought to you by Bud Light.
Lillard's going to tee up a three, and he splashes it through from the left wing.
The choice to enjoy is easy. Easy to drink, easy to enjoy.
Bucks fall to the Kings for the first time in over 8 years on Tuesday night.
De'Aaron Fox takes it to the left side. Now drives in on Lillard, puts up a floater off the window and good with a half a second to spare. On the inbound pass, it was deflected out of bounds, and Sacramento will finish off the first half the way they started it, scoring with impunity.
And that would really be the story of the whole game as the Kings go on to win 129-94. The Bucks unable to crack 30 points in a quarter for every quarter. So that means it was a 1-3 West Coast trip for the Bucks. Luckily, they're back at home to take on the 76ers on Thursday night. That one, 7 o'clock tip-off.
This has been your Milwaukee Basketball Report on Madison's home for Bucks basketball. 100.5 ESPN, brought to you by Bud Light.
Free Food Friday on ESPN Madison is brought to you by Vintage Brewing Company. Whether you're looking to get carry-out, delivery, or dine-in, Vintage Brewing has lots of great options on their menu. Vintage Brewing Company prides themselves on being a great place to hang out and enjoy classic Midwestern hospitality. Vintage Brewing Company has multiple award-winning beers, so be sure to try one the next time you're in. Head to VintageBrewingCompany.com to make a reservation today. That's VintageBrewingCompany.com.
Time to start thinking about a summer job? Jesse Nelson here, and Madison School and Community Recreation is now hiring for many positions, including day camp and youth program leaders, outdoor adventure staff, support staff for individuals with disabilities, sports instructors and officials, and more. Full and part-time positions with daytime and evening hours are available. No matter your interest, schedule, or location, there's a position for everyone. At MSCR, you can make an immediate impact in the community and gain meaningful experience. Start your summer adventure today. Apply at MSCR.org.
LabCorp Clinical Trials is changing to a new name, Fortrea. While the name may be different, Fortrea combines decades of great experience and professionalism with new opportunities for clinical trial participation. It's more than a mission and more than a new name. Fortrea is dedicated to moving healthcare forward. To learn more about the future of healthcare and upcoming clinical trials, visit us at FortreaClinicalTrials.com. That's F-O-R-T-R-E-A ClinicalTrials.com.
It's Chevy truck season, and there's no better time to do what you do best. No better time to get the job done in a Chevy Silverado with best-in-class standard torque and a TurboMax engine with a 5-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty that outlasts both Ford and Ram. So kick off whatever your thing is season right, because it all starts with a Chevy truck.
See your Badgerland Chevy dealer today.
Based on latest competitive data, excludes other GM vehicles, whichever comes first. See dealer for limited warranty details based on Ford and Ram 5-year, 60,000-mile warranty on gasoline engines.
Ben Brust from Kyle Brust and Nortman to tell you how you can go to Vegas and have a chance to win $10,000. You can visit certain locations around Madison to play Papa Shot to qualify for a chance to win. The top five scorers from each location will qualify for the finals on March 19th, and that winner will win a trip to Vegas courtesy of Bud Light to compete in the National Mini Hoops Championship and get $10,000 for winning that. On March 15th, visit Danny's from 7 to 8, Red Rock from 8 to 9, and Chasers 2.0 from 9 to 10.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
You know what that music means. You hear him every weekday on the Homer Hour with Bryan Bulaga, with John Anderson, with Tony Smith, with Gary Ellerson, and occasionally with me, at least for a segment or two. You hear him on the Marquette Men's Basketball Radio Network, and you can find him on YouTube, which many of you are watching us on YouTube, so after you're done, check out God Talk, My Faith with Homer and Pip. It is Steve Homer, True Homer. Good morning. How are you?
I'm good. Have you guys set up the parade?
The parade?
Yeah, Packer fans should be happier than they've ever been. Need a free agent. Need to spend big money. Goody did exactly what people have wanted for years, and he did it. When's the last time they anteed up as high on the food chain as they have with Xavier McKinney? Reggie White?
Yeah, $68 million is a lot to an outside free agent.
Shouldn't we all be happy? This is what you wanted, right?
Well, I mean, they did pay a defensive player, and defense really doesn't matter anymore.
Yeah, why do you do this? See, this is what's annoying about you. You sit and complain when we get in these arguments, but then you prod the Bulls.
I was just making a joke. That's it. Just a joke. It's just a joke.
No, I just meant.
You're a prodder. You are Woody Woodpecker. He's Woody Woodpecker. Instigate. And then stand back like you didn't do anything.
And if the price of him doing that is that you lose Aaron Jones for Josh Jacobs, no problem.
I don't know about that.
What do you mean? Are you not, on a scale of 1 to 10, isn't the signing of Xavier McKinney a 10? You haven't had a 10 in 30 years.
Well, on paper, it's great.
Of course it's on paper. It's on paper every year.
Do you ask yourself why the New York Giants would let a stud that's 24 years old walk out of their building? Didn't have to.
I didn't.
Why did
I
they
have
do
an
it?
Because they're not a good organization. They're a mess.
That's it?
Wanted an answer. I gave it to you. Well, answer, Jason, are the New York Giants a mess?
They are, according to a story in the New York Post, and I'm quoting here,
McKinney did circle back to the Giants, but in keeping with their beliefs regarding positional value, they deemed the price was too high for a safety. They do not value safeties, apparently, with the New York Giants.
Why not tag him? He's 24. He's been great for them. He's a captain. Like, what are you doing?
And he's 24. He was a second-round pick. If your second-round picks play as well as McKinney did, you re-sign them like you did with Elton Jenkins in Green Bay for a guard, which is his position. Regardless
but
if he's good,
he's
good.
All of us should be incredibly excited. And Homer, I'm not going to tell you should apologize because I am going to be so nice to you today. I am going to be so nice.
And I'm the instigator.
But what you always say is, oh, great, they're in the conversation. Oh, great, they're in the conversation. And then all of a sudden, before free agency actually opens, biggest running back or second biggest running back on the table, ba-bam, bring him in, pay that man his money. Biggest safety, we got to pay him a buckload of cash, ba-bam, bring him in. So do you,
said they should have a parade. And you downplayed all of it. What about this? What about this? Who's now? Oh, what do you mean? How many questions did he have, Jason, about, I don't know about this guy?
Because, Homer, I always, this doesn't matter if it's around the trade deadline, whenever there is a young player that is viewed as being a stud or the best at their spot, and the team that currently has them, with all of the tools you can to keep players, when they don't, I always have a red flag that pops up and said, why? Why did they not? Is it there's three players in that draft class that they can't tag? Okay, I'm good with that. But just like Antoine Winfield down with Tampa, Tampa couldn't get a deal. They tagged him because they didn't want him walking out the building because good organizations don't let good, young, ascending players out of their building. So it could be as simple as what you said. Maybe the New York Giants just don't know what the hell they're doing.
So, again, Joe Shane is their general manager, and from Connor Hughes of The Athletic, he made the – or SNY, I guess he's at now. Xavier McKinney and Saquon Barkley were not re-signed because Shane didn't want to tie a bulk of the Giants' resources to what he deemed as non-premium positions. Pass rusher is a premium position. They traded for Brian Burns and then gave him a five-year, $141 million contract. Whether or not that is a smart business move goes to Homer's point about whether or not they know what the hell they're doing, right? That's what that is.
How much they giving their quarterback? How are they doing?
All right. So I think we've come to the conclusion the Giants know what they're doing because they could have franchise tagged or transition tagged this young man and gotten some capital back, and they didn't do that. So, yeah, I'm going to just chalk it up. They don't know what the hell they're doing. Mm-hmm. All right,
now,
fair enough.
I
Good
do
answer,
not
Homer.
Wish to apologize. The importance of my opinion about the Packers not doing anything is because that was accurate, and that people need to know that because that's why this year needs to throw a parade. Because unlike all the other years, which were crap, this year they did something, and it is different. And for whatever reason, I don't know, now people get what they want. I thought they're parades. Everybody's upset with Aaron Jones leaving. If you lose Aaron Jones for Josh Jacobs so that your GM pays huge money for a player he believes in, do it every year.
Okay. You're just being nice, so you're not going back and forth with them today. Is that the MO?
No, I mean, I understand Homer's point, but I do think the Aaron Jones component and the leadership and the fact that you were so adamant, not you, Brian Gutekunst, was so adamant about it, it does make me wonder, you know, and Josh and Hartland yesterday sent that text in, and it really made me remind myself that I don't think they were as all in on Aaron Jones as we all were led to believe.
Of course not.
Well, I was wrong. Yeah, I was wrong.
We were all wrong, but if Goody could do anything, he just would have never made that comment. They think Josh Jacobs is way better than Aaron Jones. Way better. And you know how you know that? By the money.
It's true.
And
yeah,
it's
tough
this
to argue
isn't
with you on that.
Dean or whatever. This is about talent. This is not business. This is talent. They could have gotten Aaron Jones for 1 year for how much?
Well, I'm sure he would have signed for the same amount that he is getting from the Vikings, which is.
And what are they paying Jacobs for this first year?
They're $14 million in the first year.
Yes.
Double.
Yes. They don't think it's close. Now, they could be wrong. That's the tough part in the NFL and everything, of judging talent. But this has nothing to do with anything other than they think Josh Jacobs is way better than Aaron Jones. Not a little better. Way better.
And to Homer's point, just circling back, having confirmed this with some searching, Joe Shane, the GM of the Giants, is in his second year as the GM. He is the one who paid Daniel Jones. That was not like a previous GM who was then subsequently moved on from. He's the guy who decided that. So to Homer's point, they maybe just don't know what they're doing. That very
and
well
I
could be
emphasize.
The case.
Yeah. It could be a bad move by Goody. It could be, but this is what, myself included, you know, if you think you're good, you know, participate. And he picked a guy to say, there can be a lot of other reasons. But they haven't done this since. I think it's the closest thing to Reggie White in terms of free agent signing, given how high up on the food chain and how much they're paying. Is that there's somebody in the
That's
process?
Woodson
wasn't anywhere near this. He was at the end when nobody wanted him, right?
Yes, they outbid another team for Xavier McKinney. It was the Eagles. I think we have to be a little bit careful about mentioning Xavier McKinney and Reggie White in the same sentence.
No, they're not. There's no. I agree. This is about the investment they made. Xavier McKinney will never, in his greatest day, be able to hold. Do they use the jackstrap anymore?
Will be candle able too. To.
No, never in his life will he ever be compared as a player to Reggie White ever. No.
Well, he just was.
Except by you.
He just was.
Signing.
He literally just did that.
Signing the as I put it. The amount of money and how high up the food chain, because you can't, you know, it's more money now than 20 years ago, but it's how high. I mean, this was one of the first early signings. And when's the last time they did a first early signing?
It was 2019 when they signed Za'Darius Smith, Preston Smith, Adrian Amos, and Billy Turner all on the same day. And they moved on from Nick Perry that day as well.
None of them were anywhere near as high up the food chain at that time as Xavier McKinney was this year, right?
I mean, Xavier McKinney was an established starter and a team captain. Za'Darius Smith turned out to be a very good signing for 2 years, but he certainly hadn't accomplished as much in Baltimore as McKinney had in New York.
What they had to pay is that's part to me.
Yeah,
about what
top
they had
dollar
to pay.
For McKinney.
More than top dollar, perhaps. And I think it speaks to how important they believe with their new defensive coordinator the safety position is, which is obviously different than what the Giants think. Otherwise, they wouldn't have let Xavier McKinney walk. Homer, what else have the Packers done that you're excited about? They've moved on from some people. They brought back Keyshawn Nixon. They moved on and watched as Simone Biles' husband, Jonathan Owen, signed with the Bears. Anything else that has happened in free agency that has really piqued your interest?
No, it's all a one. It's what they do every year. This is, this is a 10. There's nothing, I don't know, you know, I mean, there's no way anything can be as big as this. But I'm amazed that nobody's really, you know, everybody should love Goody. Finally, isn't this what everybody has asked for? And it must mean.
Jason, do you love Goody?
Both of you. What?
Yeah. No, yeah, Jason
like
has been the.
It has to.
Jason's been a critic.
About them.
I'm not voting for him for vice president. That's for sure.
Are you voting for him as GM of the year?
No. I don't know who.
Let me ask, on a scale of 1 to 10, how happy are you that the Packers went into the free agent world at the highest level on a scale of 1 to 10? I'm
nine.
At a 10.
I'm at a 9.
Jason?
Yep.
I'm not at any number. I'm not happy or not happy. I want to see now if Xavier McKinney plays at the level that they paid him at.
That's what I want to see. Is he a field-tilting player? Because they signed a guy to a $68 million contract at a position that they haven't been good since they lost Nick Collins. They drafted HaHa Clinton-Dix in the first round. They drafted Darnell Savage in the first round. They've tried signing lower-level free agents to fix the position. They have not been good enough at safety.
Rudy Ford had a big game against the Cowboys a couple years ago.
My guy, Rudy Ford, but it has not been sustainable. So I'm not happy or sad about how much they paid him. I want to see if he lives up to what they paid him. I want to see if he turns out to be good enough that it justifies a $68 million contract. I want to see if they have a safety who is going to tilt the field. Because if he's not, and he's just another guy, then what happens is you have to go back and say, well, Joe Shane may not know what he's doing at quarterback for the Giants, but maybe he was right not to overpay a safety. So we're going to find out if he's good.
No, I agree. But, Jason, I want to go back. You have great articles. I'm wondering how many times in the past you've written an article after free agency saying, why don't the Packers ever, you know, why don't they ever make moves at the end of free agency? Did you ever write that article in terms of wondering why they didn't?
I think that there have been a few instances where maybe there was a free agent that you thought if they were going to spend, this guy would be worth it. But I don't, their MO has never been this. They are, the story that I wrote heading into free agency was that I expected them to be something other than discount bargain hunters. I thought that McKinney made sense. Am I surprised they actually signed him? Yes. I thought they would get like the guy from the Rams, some discounted players, guys that play the position not quite as well and not as established and certainly not as expensive. That's what I thought that they would do. And they didn't. They spent bucko bucks on Xavier McKinney. And now we're going to find out if he's worth it.
No, the thing that what we have to find out, and only you can do it, is asking Goody why. You haven't done, how many years has been in the gym? He did the four small, but why? Never before. It makes me think they must believe they got a special team.
Well, I think what it means is the last several years, they didn't have the fiscal wherewithal to do it. I think Goody probably wanted to do more like he did in 2019, but he had a four-time NFL MVP, eating up a bunch of cap space. He kept pushing money into the future, and that's what was great about last year, is that they were able to eat all of Rodgers' money and still reach the NFC divisional round and be on the precipice of an NFC championship game berth. That's why he had the guts to say that it's a great day for the Jets and it's a great day for the Packers, that they were eating $40 million of dead cap money on Aaron Rodgers. That's
hey, Homer, before we let you go, would Joe Douglas make that trade if it was today?
You mean with Rodgers?
Yeah. Well, yeah. Let's
say happy birthday, Mr. Vice President.
He didn't think he'd be hurt. If he don't, that's the only thing that changed. That got hurt, right?
And he's running for vice president. Other stuff.
Fine, I'll vote for him.
Other stuff too.
I'm voting for him. Put me down. And now I just want to let you know. It's a wasted vote, and I understand that. Because I got the same chance of being vice president. You do. Actually, Tausch, you'd be a better vice president then. You are fit.
Okay.
You know, you should run for governor. Jesse Ventura could be the governor of Minnesota. You can be the governor of Wisconsin.
All right, somebody already tried that when we first started.
Yeah.
Homer, thanks.
You bet, bye.
That was way too nice today. That was just too cordial. Like,
not only that, but when I tried to poke the bear and be an instigator, then he got mad at me. Now you're admitting that
I was really mad at you.
Too nice.
You think I was really mad at you?
I don't. Really? But I do think you're really mad when you don't do very well on Prize Picks.
I do get I get very, very irritated when my Prize Picks don't go well. I had that little teaser with Joker, my guy. He's always good to old T. You got basketball season in full swing. You got the college hoops. You got women's college hoops. You got NBA. It is fun. Get on in there. Join up with Prize Picks. Select two or more players. Pick more or less on their projection for a wide variety of stats. And just place your entry. It's that easy. Prize Picks will match that first deposit of up to $100. Just download the Prize Picks app. Use the code WI. Again, that's code WI on Prize Picks for a first deposit match of up to $100. Prize Picks. Pick more, pick less. It's that simple.
For those of you waiting for Xavier McKinney talk, it happened during our conversation with Homer, and it will continue next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin Sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
Hey, it's Jesse Nelson. Summer is coming, which means for many of you, it might be time to start thinking about a summer job. Madison School and Community Recreation is now hiring for many positions, including day camp and youth program leaders, outdoor adventure staff, support staff for individuals with disabilities, sports instructors and officials, my personal favorite, and more. I was an official growing up, and it was just such a great experience. I still use a bunch of the skills that I learned doing that in my everyday work right now. Full and part-time positions with daytime and evening hours are available, and no matter your interest, schedule, or location, there's a position for everyone. At MSCR, you can make an immediate impact in the community and gain meaningful experience. Start your summer adventure today. Apply at MSCR.org. That's MSCR.org.
You, rah, rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by Stoughton Trailers. Big trailers and big opportunity at Stoughton Trailers. Positions now open in production, operations, finance, sales, engineering, supply chain, and more. To apply today, go to stojobs.com. On Tuesday, the Big Ten announced its all-conference team selections for men's basketball, and four Badgers make the list. A.J. Storr headlined the selections, making the All-Big Ten second team and becomes the first Badger second team selection since Brad Davison in 2022. Chucky Hepburn and Tyler Wall each earned their second honorable mention accolades in their careers. And freshman John Blackwell became the ninth player in program history to earn Big Ten All-Freshman Team accolades. The Badgers are set to tip off Big Ten tournament action Thursday afternoon.
Get no interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Don't wait. You have to order by March 31st. Visit PellaWI.com.
Join the Madison Money Guy, Christian Finfrock, for retirement income strategies Saturday and Sunday mornings at 7. Get the information you need as you plan for retirement. That's retirement income strategies Saturday and Sunday mornings at 7. Investment advisory services offer the retirement income strategies and SEC-registered investment advisor.
Ben Brust here to tell you about the Princeton Club. I joined the Princeton Club because I was looking for a place I could invest in my health, and the environment and the community I have felt has made it so easy for me to incorporate it into my everyday life. It doesn't matter where you're at in your fitness journey, because they have something to offer everyone. It also goes beyond fitness. From the moment you walk in the club to the moment you walk out, there is a togetherness felt throughout the members and staff that keeps you going for your better tomorrow. Don't wait any longer and get started on your fitness journey today at PrincetonClub.net. That's PrincetonClub.net.
Mark Tauscher here, and when I was on the hunt for a hot tub, I found Patio Pleasures, a locally owned family business. Patio Pleasures has a passion for making your home a place for recovery and relaxation. And that's why I'm excited about my new cold plunge from Patio Pleasures. They only showcase premium recovery and relaxation products, and that's how I know it's going to be great. Gear up for spring and check out Patio Pleasures' two incredible showrooms, Madison West and Sun Prairie.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
From the biggest plays on the court to the comments made in the locker room after, an in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in Six provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in Six on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now on bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
There's a new safety in town.
Xavier McKinney is somebody who is what exactly we're looking for this defense. Talk about knees, talk about fit. This is a great fit for this defense.
Nobody covers the green and gold like 100.5 ESPN.
see it's over if I'm breathing. Racing to the moonlight and I'm speeding. I'm headed to the stars, ready to go far. I'm star walking. Don't ever see it's over if I'm breathing. Racing to the moonlight and I'm speeding. I'm headed to the stars.
Thanks to Homer. Very cordial, you two. Very, it was just.
Yeah, it's nice.
It just warmed your heart.
Yeah. Nice little segment.
It was a nice little segment during which we talked about Xavier McKinney. It's a 10, and he used Reggie White's name in the conversation?
Yeah, it was pretty strong. Pretty strong by Homer there. I'm not going that far. I do love the fact. We've heard now, we've been doing this show a long time. And
indeed,
we always hear they're in the conversation, and I always enjoy it because for a while there wasn't even, we weren't even in conversations. It was, well, maybe, well, we'll be, blah, blah, blah. And with Goody, it's always been, we're going to listen, we're going to, you know, sniff our noses around, and typically you don't do anything. And by the way, typically, it's not a bad thing. Some of the best deals are the deals you don't make.
Correct.
I.e. That wideout for that the Bears took. Ended up being a horrible move. So, from Pittsburgh.
Chase Claypool.
So, in this case, Claypool. In this case, there is a position we all knew was a spot the Green Bay Packers need to improve. The best player, who is not some 30-year-old, kind of getting washy, he's a 24-year-old in the prime elevator years of his career, and you're willing to go pay top dollar to do it. It's just something we're not accustomed to for a lot of reasons. The Packers don't like doing it that way. They like promoting from within, and they typically have not had the cap space to go make a splash of that magnitude. Here we are, and with being able to dump the Rodgers contract and eat all that money last year, it opens you up to build some of the other parts of your football team, and you hit it with the right quarterback, and it has all the lining up of for a long, nice run at chasing championships, which is what all fans are hoping for.
We'll talk more about Xavier McKinney to kick off the 10 o'clock or the 11 o'clock hour here momentarily. I want you to consider this. What is more likely? He becomes the next Nick Collins, or we look back 4 years from now and say, boy, I wonder if they can get out of this last year of his contract. They overpaid for this guy. Contemplate that while you contemplate how you never feel that way when you're walking out of Quick Trip like I was last night with a tasty smoothie for Sydney, and I may have done the two for reals for $7 and gotten two of them for myself, which I still think is probably not the idea behind that promotion, but I did it anyway.
Well, y'all know what a big fan I am of Quick Trip and how they do so many things right. Sarah's been gone. We stopped last night, and Maxie just got some boneless chicken wings. That's what he did last night. They got the great customer service, yep. Yeah, right about there. Yeah, they headed on the far right side. We went between the chicken sandwich, and we didn't know. Max wanted the boneless wings. Go ahead, grab them. And you see down by my feet, you got those sauces. Love
those
that buffalo
feet?
Sauce that they got there. They make some of the best chicken we've ever had. Fried chicken, chicken tenders, roasted whole chicken, the rotisserie chicken. And I think today is Wednesday. I will put their chicken mano-a-mano up against any competition. If you haven't tried it, what are you waiting for? Get into Quick Trip. Pick some up. Today is a great day to do it. 8-piece tenders, or you can get the bone-in chicken. It's just $9.99. It's perfect for quick and easy dinners. You have until April 8th, but wait. Oh, wait. There's more. You could win Quick Trip fried chicken for life. Not for tomorrow. Not next
after
week.
After breakfast.
Not for breakfast. You can have it for breakfast, but you could get it for life. Get automatically entered for a chance to win by purchasing any fried chicken product using your Quick Rewards. Get tenders, bone-in, boneless, crispy chicken sandwiches. Buy it with your rewards and be entered for a chance to win. 1 8-piece of bone-in fried chicken a week for life. You must be 18 years or older. See full details at quicktrip.com/friedchickenforlife.
Not tomorrow, not after breakfast, now.
We still don't have that, huh? We still don't have that all dialed up.
I will have that for you at the top of the 11 o'clock hour. So that means I've got 2 minutes. It's Wilde and Tausch.
Don't go anywhere. Another hour of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tauscher here, and there is one thing I think everyone can agree on. Potholes stink. And this year's weather will make it one of the worst years yet. Well, Johnson & Sons Paving is ready to take on the challenge with a team that has over 2 decades of experience. When the potholes pop up in your asphalt, Johnson & Sons Paving can patch or replace the whole area. Book an appointment now at johnsonandsonspaving.com. Get that appointment booked before May 31st, and you might even see Old T on the job site for a visit. Find full contest details at ESPN Wisconsin Contest.
Hey, this is Craig Karmazin. Join Kyle Wallace and me every Sunday morning for Sunday Karma on a Good Karma Brands radio station, 100.5 ESPN, WTLX, Monona, Madison.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio, this is your Metro Kiev Madison Sports Center.
Good morning, Madison and streamers everywhere. I'm Jesse Nelson. Sports Center brought to you by ESPN Wisconsin's coverage of the WIAA Boys Basketball State Tournament. It tips off tomorrow afternoon, starting at 1 o'clock, including all 5 state championship games Saturday, right here on 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand. NFL free agency continuing to be a frenzy up until the 3 o'clock deadline this afternoon, at which point teams can officially begin signing free agents. The Packers already have agreed to terms with a number of players, including safety Xavier McKinney, running back Josh Jacobs, and more. Plenty to recap it all. ESPN Packers reporter Rob Domofsky has it covered over at ESPNWisconsin.com. That's also where you can find ESPN's panel of NFL experts sharing their grades for the moves that the Packers have made so far in free agency. The latest, Corey Ballantyne, Keyshawn Nixon agreeing to return with the Green Bay Packers. NFL Network's Ian Rappaport sharing this morning that running back A.J. Dillon, an unrestricted free agent, drawing some interest from the Dallas Cowboys, among other teams. Stay tuned for all the latest. Wilde and Tausch have it covered right now.
Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or MetroKiaOfMadison.com.
Continues with Xavier McKinney conversation and the question that I asked Tausch, because look, Tausch, here's the thing, and we got Homer comparing this to signing Reggie White, which I know he wasn't comparing it directly. He was saying the biggest signing or whatever he wanted to call it since Reggie White. I understand that Charles Woodson was not going on a tour the way Reggie was when I watched that 30 for 30 recently, but he was a name player. Xavier McKinney is not in the name category because he's only played 4 NFL seasons. He was a second-round pick. This was the end of his rookie deal. He is an ascending player. I understand everybody being excited. Compounding that is that the Packers very rarely do this. So that adds to the excitement. And they got Josh Jacobs, who led the NFL in rushing 2 years ago. So there is legitimately and deservedly a lot of excitement. But we see these other teams who we talk about, and we kind of do it derisively, right? Oh, congratulations, you won the offseason. We don't hang banners for winning the offseason. I know we've said that on this show. The Packers right now are one of the teams
that were spending and got two very highly regarded players, you could say they're winning the offseason. So in the end, will we find ourselves feeling really good about them winning this offseason? Or will we be saying, oh, another team, except this time it was the team that we pay the closest attention to, who spent big in free agency, and it didn't work out?
Well, I mean, I would think that we'll say really nice work in, you know, plugging a couple spots and not getting desperate when it became draft time. But that's the beauty of this. You can do – you have to always kind of keep in mind the chemistry of your football team. You are bringing two alpha dogs that will probably be captains on this football team in your building. And that always is, especially with young guys that have not proven themselves, the big thing that they're going to have to fight against is selfishness. This, the team is going to, now you get, everybody as rookies is, oh, they're happy to be there.
Right.
Then all of a sudden, you start looking at it and you say, oh, well, so-and-so just got this big fat contract. Oh, how do you balance that competitive juice with still being a team and finding the role that you need to fit in order to make it work? That's a big task that, you know, not only Goody, but Matt LaFleur and Halfley and his staff have to figure out, because the NFL is inherently an incredibly selfish business. You better have your own interest in mind. Mm-hmm. How you can balance that, and you hopefully have two guys now that feel like they're all in with this organization because the organization has paid them that way, and they can lead and be those guys that are doing it. But it is not as easy as just saying, man, a couple plays here or there, and they're in the, and why I was so disappointed after that Niners game was because that was an opportunity missed, and like Dan Campbell said after they got beat, you don't know you're going to get back there. Yeah, you can love the fact you got all this youth, but that does not guarantee you jack. You know, my Mount Everest talk, that's the reality. They are all back, and they got to climb. And you got a lot of youth and vigor, and there are going to be a lot of people that want to climb and get up there and clean some of that garbage up on Mount Everest. But they have to be willing to also – there's going to be some steps where they fall down and they got to catch a rope, or they got to stop, you know, get that ice pick and throw it in there, because it ain't going to be a steady, easy climb. There's going to be tumultuousness on that route. Do you have the character to fight through it? We don't know all of that yet. We certainly are optimistic, but this is a whole new team now with no Aaron Jones. I know David wasn't around a ton last year, but no David. No Devondre Campbell. You're going to have to figure out who those guys are and how everything shakes out. Some guys are going to emerge as the guys in that wideout room. And if you don't think there's going to be a little bit of jealousy and other things, how you hold that all together, that's the part that makes it tough as coaches. And how you balance that is going to tell you whether you're going to continue to ascend or if you're going to crumple up and you're going to fall avalanche down and have to reset in 25.
Specifically when it comes to McKinney, when you look back on that 2019 free agent class, Za'Darius Smith had two great years. Then he developed that mysterious back injury when his guaranteed money ran out and he was out the door after barely playing in the 2021 season. Adrian Amos played all 4 years, never missed a game. Mm-hmm. You could argue, though, that he didn't have a whole lot of impact in those four seasons either. Great leadership, great guy, not a whole lot of splash plays. Billy Turner was an offensive lineman.
Interception in the first Bear game, first win for Matt LaFleur. I'd say that's splashy.
That was, yeah. Not many, though. Billy Turner played a lot of positions across the offensive line. Was released after the third year of his four-year contract. And Preston Smith had some ups and downs, took a pay cut, achieved some of the incentives to get some of that money back. Does Xavier McKinney have to outperform all four of them for this to have been a great signing?
I mean, Za'Darius Smith was in talks to be a defensive player of the year. Was
for
he
2 years, yeah.
I mean, mm-hmm. yeah, he was really super good. Impactful. I think we need McKinney to be a leader on that defense and to shore some things up. I don't need him to be
Nick Collins.
Rod Woodson, Troy Polamalu. No, I want him to be a Nick Collins type where you
That's
got
a pretty
really
big ask.
Good production.
That's a demand.
It
though.
Is. So is paying $18 million in the open market with great – help me out with the quote. With great responsibility comes great expectations.
No, it's the other way around.
Okay. Yeah, help me out with it. How does the quote go?
With great power comes great responsibility, I believe. So that's I don't know what power thinking. He has, but with a great contract. Well, that's what the quote is.
Spider-Man.
There's something, and it's in the political realm, where if you have a lot of power, with great power becomes great responsibility. Maybe that is what it is. He has great power. Yeah, no, put your hands down, Nelson. The old rascal. I think there is a huge expectation now for him to be a stud.
Yes.
He can't be, no offense to Rudy Ford or to Jonathan Owens.
Or to Adrian Amos.
Savage. He needs to be a stud. And if he's not, you're going to be disappointed. And so for all you guys that tell me draft pick spots don't matter as far as expectation and how that goes, it's all just hogwash.
Mm-hmm.
Because if he signed a vet minimum deal, we're not having these conversations. You get paid big, you got to play big. Simple. So here you go. Kudos to you. You've earned it. Now you got to show it. And by his tweets this morning, outside of asking for Bart Starr's number, he's letting all of us know he hadn't done jack in this league. He is ready to roll. And that gets me, as a fan, excited. So I want him to be a ball hawk. I love some of the film. JMP from West Palm, ESPN West Palm, he put some film out. We've seen some where he's up on the line of scrimmage one play, making plays. He's in the backfield making plays. He's lined up at linebacker making plays. He covers a lot of ground. He's picking things off. He's doing this. That's what you need. And I think with what Halfley's going to try to do with the aggressiveness, read, react, and go. And if he's able to do that and make you guys have said that defense isn't as important. And I'm not trying to be a smart blank here. But what I'm saying is you better be impactful. You're going to give some stuff up in today's NFL. But when you get opportunities to make those big plays, and I hope – one of the things I have not seen or studied is what kind of tackler he is. Because this defense is going to demand you to be a good tackler. And I think one of the things where Darnell Savage fell a little bit short was open field, big space. Can he get guys on the ground? Too many times the answer was no. It's okay to give up a 7-yard run. It's not okay to have a safety in the hole, missing that, and then guys going to the crib. That's how you get your blank beat. That's what happened in San Fran. McCaffrey had a 6-yard gain. Tackle him. Nope. Slip. Boop. Tutter.
39-yard touchdown.
Ball game.
Yep.
That's the blank that gets you beat, and that's the stuff that they bring McKinney in to be the guy that's not going to have that happen to him.
One quick thing I wanted to add before we get to Wilde and Tausch Double Trivia Wednesday with Wisconsin Geography. Matt Schneidman of The Athletic tweeted this yesterday, kind of right after our show ended, and we never really talked about it. I'm guessing that his source is Drew Rosenhaus. Okay. The original contract that Aaron Jones was scheduled to receive in his fourth and final year of his four-year, $48 million deal, $11 million base salary, $1 million in incentives. Again, according to Matt, final Green Bay offer, a little less than $4 million base salary, $2 million in incentives. Vikings offer $6 million base salary, $1 million in incentives. Less than $4 million as a base, that means less than $6 million with the incentives included. That is way more than a 50% pay cut.
Yeah, so if that reporting is accurate, and I have no reason to say it's not.
They didn't want Aaron Jones back.
They did not want him back. And they didn't want him back even at $4 million when they signed Josh Jacobs. Which
right,
is
because
very
you get him
surprising.
Back at that number, and now you really got a bargain
with
Josh Jacobs on your team.
I think the Green Bay Packers just assumed that Aaron Jones loved Green Bay and was going to take that offer, a lot like they did with Jordy Nelson way back in the day. And in both cases, I think the players needed to do what was right by them. So Aaron Jones has every right to be irritated about it, but he also knows he's been around long enough. He's had to take a pay cut. He knows the business. I think he probably expected that for someone that has done what he's done, that the Packers would take good care of him. And the Packers did what the Packers needed to do to make their football team better. It's tough. It's a cold-blooded business. And I think Aaron Jones found that out on Tuesday.
Let's play some trivia. It's double trivia Wednesday. It's
Monday, right? It was Monday. Monday is when he got the
Well, no, I think Friday, actually, of last week is when they told him this was our final offer. And then he said, no, thank you. And then they said, we're going to go in a different direction. And then they cut him on Monday because they didn't want him changing his mind after they'd already agreed to terms.
No, they wanted him to be able
with
to go
Josh Jacobs. They wanted him to sign somewhere. They wanted to give him an opportunity to find a different place.
Well, you do wonder, would Josh Jacobs have agreed to that if Aaron Jones was not on that? Right? Like, that's the game that you play, right? And it's kind of a shell game. And once you got that commitment, it was – thank you for your service, 33.
$11 million.
We're now going to give your number to Garendo when he is our draft pick in the third round.
$11 million to under $4 million. Wow. Why?
Well, they were never paying him. They were never paying him.
$11. I understand.
I'm a little surprised they didn't just say, we'll give some void years, we'll give you six, and you can earn another one in incentives. I still think even with paying Josh Jacobs, I still feel like that would have been the right move. But that's not the way Goody and the boys looked at it. And if you do that, then you maybe can't get the Jordan Love deal done. There is a final thing that you have to look at. But if you really wanted Aaron Jones, don't say it's a salary cap thing because that's hogwash. You have decided that you didn't really want him
correct
as a part of the team.
Mm-hmm.
That's what this tells you.
We want caller 5 and caller 10 to play trivia with us. Caller 5 and caller 10, 844-770-3776, 844-770-3776. We will play coming up next. Tausch is going to remind us again about how much Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin can do for you.
If you wanted a new backfield, a new defensive back, well, the Packers did that. And if you're looking to replace broken windows or doors, or you just want to revitalize that roster or revitalize your home with a new look, now is the time to get it done. Because from now until March 31st, you get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. That's right, Pella now and pay it later, 3 years later. In fact, order by March 31st. To get 0% interest for up to those 3 years. Set your free consultation today at PellaWI.com. Certain restrictions do apply.
Trivia's next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Mark Tauscher here for Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie, the name you can trust. Well, if you're in your car right now, or even a little while from now, you may realize that this is the time of year it's at its dirtiest. Spilled food and liquids, scratches and dirt, stinky hockey gear, and of course, salt and sand everywhere. Well, if your vehicle is in need of some quality care, I highly recommend you check out the detailing service at Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie. Well, this service is incredible. It will make your vehicle feel as new as the day you first drove it off the lot. The interior detail is the deep clean you know your car needs. Carpet and upholstery shampooed. Leather and vinyl surfaces are dressed. Interior windows are cleaned from your dash to your doors. Every interior surface gets that thorough cleaning. And maybe most importantly, especially for the Tauscher crew, your vehicle gets fully deodorized. And the exterior detail is much more than a car wash. It includes getting rid of tar and bugs, a light buffing, a wax, a deep cleaning of the wheels, and much, much more. You can choose to get an interior detail, exterior detail, or get the complete detail where you get both. Learn more and check out their full new and used vehicle inventory at ZimbrickChevrolet.com. The detailing service at Zimbrick Chevrolet. The name you can trust.
Gold medalist Matt Hamilton, judgmental Jim Rutledge, Rutledge and Hamilton.
The margin for error for Love and LaFleur will get thin or widen depending on just how much of an improvement Hathley's unit can make this upcoming season.
What you do late in the season, you can carry over that mentality and that momentum. I love what Jordan Love was doing at the end of the year.
Rutledge and Hamilton with Jim Rutledge and Matt Hamilton. Presented by Coors Light. Weekdays 4 to 6 on 100.5 ESPN. Also brought to you by J&K Security Solutions.
For official rules and more information about every contest on 100.5 ESPN, visit ESPNWisconsinContest.com. That's ESPNWisconsinContest.com. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN app.
What does it take to make a diamond? Extreme heat and pressure and about a billion years. But you can't wait that long. What do? You go to Goodman's Jewelers. I'm John Hayes from Goodman's Jewelers. There's a reason we are the Diamond Store of Madison. Since 1933, we've provided outstanding service and selection to our customers. And that, in turn, has helped to establish countless great memories through the years. GoodmansJewelers.com, located at 220 State Street. Truly a destination worth reaching.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit CelebrationsEntertainment.com. That's CelebrationsEntertainment.com.
Since J&K Security Solutions opened in 1987, our attention to detail and customer service have been our strongest assets. I'm President Jeffrey Beckman. We'll always do our best to find the most efficient and cost-effective solution to every job we tackle. Whether it's security for your home or business, installing video surveillance, or being able to control your garage doors from your phone, we can help you feel empowered with simple and user-friendly technology. Let's work together to secure your home or business. JKSecurity.com.
Join Prairie Athletic Club and spring forward your membership today. Hi, this is Sarah Tauscher encouraging you to save now until the end of August when you join the pack. The Platinum membership is everything you want and more, including Pilates, hot yoga, bar, unlimited training zone, and boot camp classes. Discover the ultimate wellness experience tailored just for you. Not a member? Not a problem. Guests are welcome daily. Head to PrairieAthletic.com or stop in today for all their membership specials. Prairie Athletic Club, family fun community.
Wilde and Tausch on 100.5 ESPN is brought to you by Everlight Solar. Save money, save the planet. Everlight Solar.
This ain't a good time, but when is it ever? I know the perfect time, and maybe that's never. So don't you dare leave me now. Throw my heart on the ground. Cause tonight ain't the night for sorrow.
Time for trivia. You can hurt me tomorrow. Let's welcome in our contestants to Wisconsinites for Wisconsin Geography Wednesday. First, let's welcome in Levi in Plover. Levi, good morning. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic, Jason. Thank you very much.
Great to hear from you. All right, and our second contestant is AJ in Sheboygan. AJ, good morning. How are you?
Good morning. I'm doing great, fellas. How are you?
We're outstanding. We'll see how outstanding you guys are in Wisconsin geography trivia right now. All right, question number one goes to Levi. Levi, here is your first question. If Aaron Jones leaves Green Bay driving west for Minneapolis, which of these Wisconsin cities would he see first on his drive? Is it Bonduel, Bond Triple, or Bond Quadruple? That's an awfully nice courtesy laugh there.
Answer, but wow. Jesse, that's a tough question, but I'll answer it. I would guess the second one. Final, please.
Wait, did you get that wrong on purpose? Bon Duel is a real place. Bon Triple, Bon Quadruple are not.
I think Bon Triple's up by Minocqua.
Just outside of Tomahawk. All right, AJ, you get your question one. And that is this. If Darnell Savage leaves Green Bay driving south for Milwaukee to catch a flight to Jacksonville, which of these Wisconsin cities would he see first on his drive? Is it Kohler, Coorsville, or Grubertown? One mall, that's all.
That would be the toilet capital of the world, Kohler.
All right, you've got your first one on the board. All right, let's bounce back here, Levi. Question two is this, and it's more of this driving around business. If Aaron Rodgers begins his vice presidential campaign tour in Madison and then wants to head to New Glarus, which direction would Vice President-elect Rodgers and his staff be primarily traveling? So Madison to New Glarus, Aaron Rodgers and his entourage, are they traveling southeast, southwest, or northwest?
Oh, boy. Man, I should know my Wisconsin geography on this, but I heard New Glarus, but I would guess, shrimp. I would say southeast. That's just a guess.
Southeast will take you to Bon Triple. Southwest will take you to New Glarus. All right. You still got one more left, so we'll see how that one goes. AJ, your second question is this. If Aaron Rodgers makes another campaign stop in Wisconsin, arriving in Wausau, and then determining that he's got to get to Chippewa Falls.
We got to get to Chippewa Falls.
Which direction would Vice President-elect Rodgers and his staff primarily be traveling from Wausau to Chippewa Falls? Would they be going south, west, or north?
West.
Two for two for AJ. All right, Levi, let's bounce back. Let's get question three. All right, buddy?
Let's try our best, man.
Latitudinally! Which of these high schools, featuring a team competing in the WIAA Boys State High School Basketball Tournament this weekend, is located the farthest north of these three high schools? Is it West Salem, Prescott, or Nina? West Salem, Prescott, or Nina?
Wow. I haven't paid attention to WIAA boys basketball, but I know at 125 ESPN Madison is going to be calling these games starting at 1 o'clock on Thursday. I saw an ad today on YouTube.
Nice work.
Give him an entry.
You deserve an entry for that promo.
Okay. Can you repeat your question one more time, quick, Jason?
There's nothing I'd like to do more, Levi. Let me do that again. Latitudinally! Hey, where's the horn? Which of these high schools featuring a team that is competing in the WIAA Boys State High School Basketball Tournament this weekend is located the farthest north? West Salem, Prescott, or Nina?
My final answer would be Nina.
Your final answer is incorrect.
I think it's Prescott, right?
Your answer, also incorrect. At least according to the information that has come across my desk from Jesse. West Salem
They should call it North Salem, am I right? Was the correct answer. All right, AJ. Levi took the collar. Can you have a perfect score? Question three for you is this. Longitudinally, which of these high schools featuring a team competing in the WIAA Boys State High School Basketball Tournament this weekend is located farthest east? Farthest east. Is it Lakeside Lutheran, Abundant Life Christian, or Columbus Catholic?
Ooh, that was farthest east, you said, right?
That was farthest east. Yes, farthest east. Your choices again. Lakeside Lutheran, Abundant Life Christian, or Columbus Catholic?
I'm going to take a guess at this one since he didn't say the cities, and I'll say Lakeside Lutheran.
Located in Lake Mills, I do believe. Is correct.
Wow.
Oh. Two ends of the trivia spectrum.
That's a first.
AJ, 3 for 3, you got 4 entries. Levi, 0 for 3, you got 1 entry. But hey, you never know what's going to happen when Jesse pulls out of the cheese fry helmet the winning poker chip. Good luck to you both. Thanks for playing, guys.
Yeah. Hey, I want to say something quick before you go. Next Wednesday, I'm going to go for my driver's test, and hopefully, if I pass, that could be a breaking news sounder for you, Jesse, but we'll see.
Would you like Jesse to come and provide moral support?
That is up to him.
He'll do it. It's a long drive.
He's taken time off from the show for less, so we'll talk to him about it, Levi. If we don't talk to you, good luck on your driver's test,
Levi.
Buddy.
Thanks, guys. Trisha and Rep. Robert say, I love you guys.
I love you guys.
All right. If AJ had anything to add, he didn't get the opportunity.
Sorry, AJ.
Tausch, raise a Coors Light in AJ's honor. He didn't get to say I love you guys, but he did get all the questions right.
He nailed it, and he should celebrate with a Coors Light brewed with a 3-step cold process, cold lager, cold filtered, and cold packaged, so it's made to chill. Going to be 70 degrees today. Oh, baby, that's when you need those mountains on Coors Light's cold-activated bottles and cans to be baby blue. That's when you know it's chilled to perfection. That's why it is Coors Light in my hand. When I need a moment to chill, celebrate responsibly. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado.
Whoa, Nelly, next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, driven by Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie on 100.5 ESPN. See their full inventory at ZimbrickChevrolet.com.
Get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote by listening and educating you on all of your product options. And with Design Works, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
Ben Brust here to tell you about the Princeton Club. I joined the Princeton Club because I was looking for a place I could invest in my health, and the environment and the community I have felt has made it so easy for me to incorporate it into my everyday life. It doesn't matter where you're at in your fitness journey, because they have something to offer everyone. It also goes beyond fitness. From the moment you walk in the club to the moment you walk out, there is a togetherness felt throughout the members and staff that keeps you going for your better tomorrow. Don't wait any longer and get started on your fitness journey today at PrincetonClub.net. That's PrincetonClub.net.
Mark Tauscher here to tell you a little bit more about Everlight Solar. We all know that electricity costs are on the rise. That's why you need to talk to my friends over at Everlight Solar. Their local team here in Madison is here to keep it simple. From your no-cost consultation to solar panel installation, the team at Everlight Solar will be with you every step of the way. Not only will they help you save money, but by switching to solar, you're also helping save the planet. Everlight Solar, a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Check them out at EverlightSolar.com.
What is a better buying experience? Well, you're minutes away from a better buying experience at Simden Chevy in Mount Horeb. Jim Rutledge here. To me, a better buying experience is a personal experience. That's what Dan and his sales team have set up at Simden Chevy in Mount Horeb. You're going to have the experience that you're looking for. You're going to define what that better buying experience is for you, and they're going to get you in the vehicle that you need and that you want, whether it's new or new to you. So when you're looking for a better buying experience, go to Simden Chevy in Mount Horeb.
UW Credit Union presents the Prep Mania Student Athlete of the Week, supporting local student athletes as they grow on the field, in the classroom, and in the community. UW Credit Union is here for every you. Learn more at uwcu.org. Here's Dennis Simra with the UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week.
Our ESPN Madison UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week, Andrew Jakey. First sport you ever played?
Oh, it was hockey. I was two at the time when I started skating.
Were you born to be a hockey player?
So my dad, he always wanted me to play basketball. He always coached my sister, would make me go to her practices when I was younger, and I would just sit there and cry. Fortunately for me, my neighbor, he had a son, and the dad at the time was a coach for Oregon Youth Hockey too, so they kind of brought me along into the hockey world.
When did you start playing football?
I started playing kindergarten.
But hockey's always been your love?
Yeah, football has always been a great game to do with the guys from your town, but hockey's definitely my end.
What do you love about hockey?
I would say mainly the guys that you meet, especially hockey has allowed me to travel all over, so just meet like different people and building different relationships.
Ben Brust from Kyle Brust and Nortman to tell you how you can go to Vegas and have a chance to win $10,000. You can visit certain locations around Madison to play Papa Shot to qualify for a chance to win. The top five scorers from each location will qualify for the finals on March 19th, and that winner will win a trip to Vegas courtesy of Bud Light to compete in the National Mini Hoops Championship and get $10,000 for winning that. On March 15th, visit Danny's from 7 to 8, Red Rock from 8 to 9, and Chasers 2.0 from 9 to 10.
Condon Jewelers, Condon Jewelers, the jeweler on the east side, the jeweler on your side. When you see Diamond Jim, you can count on him to be on your side. Selection beyond compare with on-site repair, so you can wear your jewelry with pride. Condon Jewelers, Condon Jewelers, the jeweler on the east side, the jeweler on your side.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
After that trivia performance, somewhere in between getting none of them right and getting them all of them right will be the quality of Woe Nelly.
If the topic is good, the guys discuss.
Just the other morning, I had breakfast at Tracy Rocker's house. His mama brought out 15 flapjacks. He said, "Mama, take back 5 of them flapjacks. I gotta stay hungry for the Crimson Tide."
But if it's not, the show must go on. It's time for
Woe Nelly
on Wilde and Tausch.
First of all, a trivia correction.
Oh, no.
I think there was some suspicion when the question was asked and the correct answer was announced. It appears that I highlighted the incorrect answer late last night.
I knew it!
Prescott is much further north than West Salem.
And I was surprised. I didn't want to be a jerk because trying to be a little nicer. Yeah, Prescott, I thought, was way north.
Levi did us a favor by answering Nina, which was incorrect regardless.
That's how she get an entry, though.
Yeah. nice job, old T.
I'm not eligible, though. That's too bad.
But you're eligible for Fortria. Jesse, when I read that, I was like, God, do I not know where West Salem is?
Prescott's way up there, and West Salem is near La Crosse.
So, Jesse, I know you're a busy guy. You're calling some state basketball tomorrow, and you're running an office and all of this stuff. How does that happen on such a consistent basis?
Well, I can tell you how this one happened last night. I spent more time on this set of trivia questions that I did on like the rest of the show rundown for today. And
I don't know if that's something I want to be admitting.
Yeah, I mean, I got distracted. The West Coast Conference Championship game was on. The dog got up, needed to go out, wanted to play with his duck for a bit. Like, there were a lot of things going on in between show sheet creation and trivia creation. As I was creating both sets of questions, originally the Prescott-West Salem question was going to ask about farthest west, in which Prescott would be the
West Salem would have been the correct answer. It says west in the title.
Yeah, I think that's how that would have worked out. Yeah.
Well, West Bend isn't that far west.
So I so had that true, highlighted.
But it's by lacrosse, as it turned out. So, I think what you should do.
It's a formatting error in this,
I don't,
this case.
I never worked in a factory, obviously. I'm in no way qualified or hardworking enough for that type of job. But I do
Very
know.
Fair.
Yeah, no, I'm self-aware, if nothing else. I do know that they usually have, like, signs in factories where it'll say, like, 32 days without a on-the-job incident. I think we need that type of sign for trivia that indicates how many days we've gone without an incident of an inaccurate answer or, error in the question.
I ain't gonna lie to you. I don't think it'd be more than 10 days.
Can we get to double digits was going to be my question as you finish yet another sentence.
We've had
it's been
a while since our last one. We've been on a really good stretch.
You missed 3 days of work.
Well, I mean, before that.
No, you definitely had one where you highlighted the wrong answer recently to it.
Yeah,
I caught it
did.
In real time and fixed it.
And then there was one I re-emailed you like right before we did it, and that was a thing.
That was a thing, yeah.
Whoa, okay. Nelly!
Well, that's all the time we have for Whoa, Nelly.
Sure is.
So, Tausch.
I'm off tomorrow, by the way.
What?
I'm off to the show tomorrow. I'm calling D3 championship, so we'll have to start that streak on Friday.
So, is that D3 champion? First off, it's a semifinal.
Semifinals,
because there's no champion.
Yep, semifinals.
And it starts at 1 o'clock,
right?
1 o'clock.
Doesn't it start at 1?
Yeah, 1 o'clock pregame at the Kohl Center.
Is our show on a different time tomorrow? Like, what am I missing here?
Well, you got to get set up and get your complimentary beverages at the Kohl Center.
It's spring forward. We're changing the clocks at noon.
I forgot daylight savings time kicked in.
Mm-hmm. Got to get your beverages ahead of the game. Got to get all set up. Yeah. You know, there's a whole process we go through over there. You can't just be rolling in 12:59, expect everything to go smooth.
That's fair, Jesse.
I do not think Prize Picks does projections on state tournament basketball games. But if they did, you know that Tausch should be checking them out along with his Giannis projections.
Indeed, I would. Prize Picks Daily Fantasy Sports made easy, and boy, it is easy. Pick two or more players. Pick more or less on their projection for a wide variety of stats, and just place your entry. It's that easy. You can turn $10 into Bonko dollars just with a couple of taps. And this is my favorite part. Prize Picks is the only daily fantasy platform with injury insurance to keep you in the game even if one of your players goes down. Right now, Prize Picks will match your first deposit up to $100. Just download the Prize Picks app. Use the code WI. Again, that's code WI on Prize Picks for a first deposit match of up to $100. Prize Picks. Pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
I have to ask briefly so we don't run out of time. Jesse, are you playing like four-dimensional chess to such a degree that you made a mistake in the trivia because you had nothing ready for Whoa, Nelly because you spent more time on trivia than the rest of the show sheet? Because as I look at Whoa, Nelly, it says, questions about the latest in NFL free agency. Which I assume means you were hoping news would break that we didn't get to.
Deontay Johnson going to have to wait.
We'll wrap things up next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tauscher here, and there is one thing I think everyone can agree on. Potholes stink. And this year's weather will make it one of the worst years yet. Well, Johnson & Sons Paving is ready to take on the challenge with a team that has over two decades of experience. When the potholes pop up in your asphalt, Johnson & Sons Paving can patch or replace the whole area. Book an appointment now at johnsonandsonspaving.com. Get that appointment booked before May 31st, and you might even see old T on the job site for a visit. Find full contest details at ESPN Wisconsin Contest.
You, rah-rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by the Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company, Madison's home for craft beer and pub food since 1994. Find the Great Dane nearest you at greatdanepub.com. On Tuesday, the Big Ten announced its all-conference team selections for men's basketball, and four Badgers make the list. A.J. Storr headlined the selections, making the All-Big Ten second team and becomes the first Badger second team selection since Brad Davison in 2022. Chucky Hepburn and Tyler Wall each earned their second honorable mention accolades in their careers. And freshman John Blackwell became the ninth player in program history to earn Big Ten All-Freshman Team accolades. The Badgers are set to tip off Big Ten tournament action Thursday afternoon.
Get no interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Don't wait. You have to order by March 31st. Visit PellaWI.com.
Join the Madison Money Guy, Christian Finfrock, for retirement income strategies Saturday and Sunday mornings at 7. Get the information you need as you plan for retirement. That's retirement income strategies Saturday and Sunday mornings at 7. Investment advisory services offer the retirement income strategies and SEC registered investment advisor.
The 24th annual Madison St. Patrick's Day Parade is taking place on Sunday, March 17th at 1:30 around the Capitol Square. Join us for an afternoon of music, dancing, and family-friendly fun featuring Emmy Award-winning Grand Marshal Brady Mallory. Don't forget incredible acts like the Kissers, Bucky Badger, the UW Marching Band, and Madison Bagpipers. Donations make it possible. Huge thanks to our sponsors, J.P. Cullen and J&K Security. Save the date, spread the word, and be part of the Madison St. Patrick's Day Parade.
ESPN Madison is on Wisconsin sports. Catch up on anything you missed on the Varsity Podcast on Wisconsin On Demand. Brought to you by Zimbrick Honda, a proud supporter of Wisconsin Badger Athletics. If you're looking to purchase, finance, or service a new or pre-owned Honda, shop local, part of the Madison community since 1973.
When it comes to security for your home and family, you want a winner, and we found one when we placed our trust with J&K Security Solutions. This is Greg Gard. Kim and Jeff hit the game-winning shot for us with the Control 4 home technology system. Home or away, from our smartphones, we can open the garage door, dim the lights, turn on the TV, as well as arm the security system. That's convenience as well as peace of mind. Let J&K Security Solutions do for your home or business like they've done for us. Call 255-5799 or online at jksecurity.com.
Time to start thinking about a summer job? Jesse Nelson here, and Madison School and Community Recreation is now hiring for many positions, including day camp and youth program leaders, outdoor adventure staff, support staff for individuals with disabilities, sports instructors and officials, and more. Full and part-time positions with daytime and evening hours are available. No matter your interest, schedule, or location, there's a position for everyone. At MSCR, you can make an immediate impact in the community and gain meaningful experience. Start your summer adventure today. Apply at MSCR.org.
I love playing sports, especially for my school. And that's because school sports are special. It's where it's safe to fail. It's where we're taught resilience, where our fear becomes confidence. It's where we learn to get back up after every fall. School sports are where 7.8 million students go from I can't to I can.
This message presented by the WIAA and the Wisconsin Athletic Directors Association.
There's a new safety in town.
Xavier McKinney is somebody who is what exactly we're looking for this defense. Talk about needs, talk about fit. This is a great fit for this defense.
Nobody covers the green and gold like 100.5 ESPN.
I say go, baby, go, go, go.
Well, Jesse's got to get ready for his WIAA State High School basketball semifinal game to call tomorrow, so he won't be on the show. Listed as questionable for tomorrow is his scheduled cousin sub of the day. Cousin subs, we believe in better, Alex Strofe. So, God willing, Tausch, you'll be here. I'll be here.
Yep.
And
yep.
Maybe it'll be Hunter Vaughn and Gerald Ford trivia.
which you should be able to get at least one right usually. That's it for us today. We will do it again tomorrow. Thanks to Bryan Bulaga, and thanks to Homer, and thanks to you. Have a great day. Take care. Be good.
Miss any of today's episode of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin? Commercial-free full show podcasts are available free on Wisconsin On Demand.